Bowl Day 68 continues. Brought to you in living color on NBC.
Hello, America. I'm Pat Taylor, queen of the 1968 Orange Bowl. Welcome to beautiful Miami, Florida, and the number one game of today's triple hitter. You'll see two of the nation's best teams, the Sooners of the University of Oklahoma and the Volunteers of the University of Tennessee. You'll also see exciting pregame and halftime pageants here at the fabulous Orange Bowl.
NBC Sports presents the 1968 Orange Bowl game. The Oklahoma Sooners versus the Tennessee Volunteers. Brought to you by the Savings and Loan Association Serving America, where over 43 million people keep their savings. By the people in your town who bottle Coca-Cola. Coke has the taste you never get tired of. By Pontiac and your Pontiac dealers. The people are having an us versus them comparison sale. By United Airlines, fly the friendly skies of United. And by Salem Filter Cigarettes. Salem refreshes your taste. This is the Orange Bowl in beautiful Miami, Florida, where the temperature today reached 80 degrees at game time, 73 degrees. This will be a rematch of the 1939 Orange Bowl game, which the experts say was the making of this great bowl, Tennessee and Oklahoma. Tennessee won that ball game by the score of 17-0. The Sooners' vow tonight will be different. Hello, everyone. I'm Jim Simpson, along with Kyle Rote, former All-American and All-Pro halfback, who incidentally still holds a bowl record, the longest punting average, back in 1949, that was, in the Cotton Bowl of 63 and a half yards. But as far as this game is concerned, Oklahoma, winners of the Big 8 title, they are 9-1. And Tennessee winning its first Southeastern Conference championship since 1956, also 9-1. And Kyle Rote, their records are not all that similar with these two ball clubs.
Well, that's true, Jim. Not only do the teams have similar offensive alignments, they have similar defensive alignments, too. Both quarterbacks, Tennessee's Dewey Warren passing to Richmond Flowers, both quarterbacks have extremely fast men to whom they can throw the ball. Oklahoma's Bob Warmack passing to Eddie Hinton. He's a 9'7 man, whereas Flowers is 9'4, so there's a little bit of difference there. But the one matchup that I'm really looking forward to seeing tonight is Oklahoma's Granville Liggins, their middle guard, or what they call their nose guard, number 66. All-American, and he'll be right across the line from Tennessee's All-America center, Bob Johnson. He's number 54, so this is really going to be a real battle, I think.
This is going to be a battle, and let's now check the schedules of Oklahoma and Tennessee this year and also look at some of their players in action. For Oklahoma, we said they're 9-1. They lost only one. That was their third game of the year to rival Texas, 9-7, and the Sooners feel they should have won that ball game. They bumped off Colorado 23-0, and of course, Colorado conquered Miami in the Blue Bonnet Bowl. And Oklahoma, to get this far, has to have great ball players, and great ball players they do have, Kyle Rote.
Well, one of their finest runners, of course, is number 22, Ron Schatz. He's a good-sized boy, and he gets some good help. He's about 200 pounds. You'll see him here. He's in the tailback spot there, taking the handoff. And either he or tailback Steve Owens, an extremely fine-looking sophomore, will be carrying the ball about 90% of the time. Schatz here, a senior, gained over 700 yards this season and 7 touchdowns. Here, quarterback Bob Warmack, as you can see, can throw the ball with extremely good accuracy. This one going to his strong side end, number 82, Steve Zabel. That was the one that beat Kansas in the final minute. And here you'll see Warmack and his ability to scramble. This one is against Iowa State. And if the Tennessee Vols expect to win the ball game tonight, this is one facet of the ball game. Walmart scrambling that they will have to contain. He's extremely good runner. And here's Oklahoma's fast wingback, Eddie Hinton, number 33, taking this pitch out. Tennessee will also have to concern themselves not only with Hinton's running that you're watching here, but he's one of the best pass receivers. And they'll be having to cover him tonight. And the big man on defense for Oklahoma, middle guard Granville Liggins, a real All-American. Tennessee's All-American center Bob Johnson, as we mentioned, will have to worry about him tonight.
And, of course, that is Oklahoma. Now for Tennessee, as we said, Southeastern Conference champions. They, too, have won 9 and lost 1. And their only loss of the season was in the only other night game they played this year. They lost to Gary Beavin and UCLA by the score of 20-16. Then they had a week off and came back and rolled, Kyle Rote, winning 9 in a row to win this Southeastern Conference championship and come on to the Orange Bowl down here in Miami. And like Oklahoma, they have great personnel also.
They really do, in their passing combination of quarterback Dewey Warren to his flanker back, Richmond Flowers, is perhaps, again, one of the big factors that will determine the outcome of the game tonight. And here we see Dewey Warren with an excellent arm, completing 59% of his passes this season, as well as last season. This to flanker Richmond Flowers with tremendous speed, as we mentioned. And tonight, the Oklahoma defensive back will have to cover Richmond Flowers as their fine young sophomore, Bruce Stensrud. There you see Flowers. Once he gets that ball, he can move. And along with Pickens and Chadwick in the backfield, Charlie Fulton, number 12, anchors down the Tennessee running game. And now look at Tennessee's All-American center, Bob Johnson, number 54. You see him maintaining that block, who, as we said, really have a head-on battle with Oklahoma's Granville Liggins tonight.
The numbers 2 and 3 teams in the country about to meet. Oklahoma taking the field, and no Orange Bowl is complete without the great pregame and halftime pageantry as put on by Ernie Siler and his committee. So now let's go down to the field for the pregame pageantry and ceremony.
Stand and remain silent as the Orange Bowl committee presents its 1968 pregame pageant, This Is My Country. Ladies and gentlemen, the Orange Bowl March.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, meet the University of Oklahoma. Number 82, a sophomore, tight end from Thornton, Colorado, Steve Zabel. Number 73, a junior, offensive tackle from Columbia, South Carolina, in special education, Byron Bigby. Number 62, a sophomore, offensive guard from Shawnee, Oklahoma, Ed Lancaster. Number 50, a senior and center from McAllister, Oklahoma, in business education, Bob Craig. Number 52, a senior defensive linebacker from Pampa, Texas, in finance, Rick Goodwin. Number 77, a senior offensive tackle from Dell City, Oklahoma, in business education, Bob Kalsu. Number 81, a senior defensive end from Burke Burnett, Texas, in political science, John Kohler. Number 11, a junior and quarterback from Ada, Oklahoma, in finance, Bob Warmack. Number 22, a senior and tailback from Weatherford, Oklahoma, in pre-law, Ron Schatz. Number 33, junior, a wingback from Lawton, Oklahoma, in special education, Eddie Hinton. Number 31, a senior and defensive back from Claremont, California, in business education, Bob Stevenson. Number 36, a sophomore tailback from Miami of Oklahoma, Steve Owens. Number 66, senior defensive guard from Tulsa, Oklahoma, in special education, Granville Liggins. Number 43, senior linebacker from Euless, Texas, in physical education, the game captain, Don Primer, and the head coach of the University of Oklahoma's football team, Chuck Fairbanks. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the University of Tennessee, number 81, a junior and defensive end from Knoxville, Tennessee, in business education, Jim McDonald. This is number 74, a junior defensive tackle from Greenville, Tennessee, in agriculture, Dick Williams. Number 75, senior offensive tackle from Pikeville, Tennessee, in education, John Boynton. Number 78, senior offensive tackle from Cedartown, Georgia, going for a BA degree, Elliot Ramage. Number 62, a senior offensive guard from Fayetteville, Tennessee, in education, Joe Graham. Number 65, a junior offensive guard from Humboldt, Tennessee, in engineering, Charles Rosenfelder. Number 54, a senior center from Cleveland, Tennessee, in engineering, Bob Johnson. Number 26, a senior defensive back from Tampa, Florida, in education, Albert Dorsey. Number 32, a senior monster man from Lafayette, Tennessee, in liberal arts, Jimmy Glover. Number 20, a senior tailback from Decatur, Georgia, going for his BA degree, Walter Chadwick. Number 34, junior fullback from Knoxville, Tennessee, also going for his BA, Richard Pickett. Number 22, a junior wingback from Montgomery, Alabama, in liberal arts, Richmond Flowers. Number 12, a senior tailback from Memphis, Tennessee, in business administration, Charlie Fulton. And number 16, the senior quarterback from Savannah, Georgia, in the School of Education, Dewey Warren. And the head coach for the University of Tennessee, Doug Dickey. And now Oklahoma and Tennessee are ready for the opening kickoff. We'll be right back for the start of the 1968 Orange Bowl game.
Here we go. All right, I get to go first.
Yeah. We're about to see the playing of a dangerous new game. It's called the credit game. Let's watch. The first player has turned up a credit card that enables him to buy another car in advance to Easy Street.
Don't worry, I got a credit card.
And here's one for a vacation tour. Here's a different kind of card, a savings account at a savings and loan association. This card may be kept until needed. And there are credit cards for boats, furniture and appliances, fur coats, most everything you'd ever want. But sooner or later, you're bound to run into a card that says, pay all bills, plus carrying charges. If you've saved at a savings and loan association, you're still in good shape. If you haven't saved, the game can be disastrous. In real life, too, the abuse of credit is a dangerous game. To win, you need a savings account at your nearby savings and loan association. Saving makes the difference.
In the dark jersey, that's Oklahoma's Don Primer, the game captain. Number 43. As the flip of the coin comes, there are tri-captains from Tennessee. Don Boynton, Albert Dorsey, and Bob Johnson right there receiving word from Pete Williams, the referee, that he has won the toss and will receive. So Oklahoma will kick off in this rematch of the 1939 Orange Bowl game. 70 degrees and clear here in Miami, Florida. We know there's much snow around and a lot of cold weather, but down here, it is simply beautiful. The game about to get underway. We pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC Television Network. Oklahoma in the dark red jerseys. Tennessee, of course, in the orange across the way as they break out. And Kyle wrote, before the kickoff, a word once more about the similarity of these two teams.
Well, they are. They both operate out of the I formation offensively. Defensively, you'll see them in a 5-2 and in a 5-3 with the monster man or free man, free linebacker, going to the strength of the offensive formation. Most of them play a zone in their deep secondary with their three deep men. Perhaps Oklahoma will go more with a man-for-man coverage than Tennessee, but they're very similar. The quarterback's throwing to very fast men, and we will get an opportunity now to see the first matchup of Oklahoma center Bob Johnson, All-American, against Granville Liggins, number 66, on middle guard, on defense for Oklahoma.
Across the way is Baker, 48, as Bajon kicks off, and Fulton, 12, also deep. There is Baker at the 12-yard line for Tennessee as the Orange Bowl is underway, and Happy New Year to you. As Bill Baker comes across the 30-yard line, across the 40, and is dumped as he hits to the 45 and spills out to the 47-yard line. Knocked down there by John Kohler, number 81, the left defensive end, and Don Primer, the game captain, number 43. Gary Criss is expected to start at split end. We'll pick these up for you. He is 91. Elliot Gamage may not play at left tackle. We'll check that for you as a pulled hamstring. Joe Graham at left guard. All-American Bob Johnson at center. Johnny Rosenfelder, right guard. John Boynton at right tackle. Kendall Long, the tight end. And Dewey Warren, Walter Chadwick, Richmond Flowers, and Richard Pickens in the backfield. We'll give you those numbers in a moment. First offensive play, this is Charlie Fulton. Fulton gets out across midfield and into Oklahoma territory. Fulton, number 12, who has played all four positions on the Tennessee team. Jim Files, number 84, and Granville Liggins, number 66, made the stop. It'll be second down and five from the 49. And John Kohler, 81, Dick Peso, 79, Granville Liggins, 66, John Titsworth, 78, Jim Files, 84, along the five-man forward wall. Wide to the left is DeLong. Long count by Dewey Ward on second down five. He throws across the way and has his man stepping out of bounds across the way by Harper is Richmond Flowers, number 22, who was not expected to play much tonight because of a virus. Kyle?
This is going to be the problem for both defensive units, but in this instant, Oklahoma, whether to come up and force Dewey Warren as he makes that option play, as he goes down the line, whether to keep it or to lateral it back to his tailback, in this case, Charlie Fulton. Most of the defensive units try to make the quarterback keep it rather than pitch it out. At least this is the Oklahoma defensive strategy.
Third down one. Warren calling signals, keeping the ball himself and trying for the first down. And we'll have to wait and see. Rick Goodwin, 52. Gary Harper, 45. Don Primer, 43, your linebackers. Bruce Denthrud, 17. Steve Barrett, 35. And Bobby Stevenson, 31, your deep men. And this is fourth down and a half a yard to go. And very quickly, we'll see how Tennessee is going to play this game. They're sending in Weaver, their kicker, Herman Weaver, who has a 38.5-yard average, but only 24 of his 54. Hold it. Weaver has not come in to do the punting. Oklahoma comes up quickly, and they're going to go for it, and they have got it by 20. Charlie pulled him down to the 34-yard line. The Oklahoma defense was getting set to receive the punt, but there was no kick.
The Tennessee offense, Jim, is a little more difficult to scout than the Oklahoma offense. For example, Tennessee spreads their running out equally pretty much between their fullback and their tailback, whereas Oklahoma pretty much runs completely with its tailback.
No score, early moments of the Orange Bowl. First down at the 35. Warren holding onto the ball. Running, he doesn't do that often, but gets down to the 29-yard line. Dewey Warren, who prefers to pass rather than run, and Don Primer, the right side linebacker, and Granville Liggins, again, combined to make the tackle. A gain of six, it'll be second down and four.
Again, we see Oklahoma trying to make Dewey Warren keep that ball. John Kohler, number 81, their defensive end to that side, playing the left defensive end, comes out, makes Warren keep the ball and go back inside rather than make the pitch out.
Harry Dalton goes wide to the left, 86. Richmond Flowers, 22 to the right. On second down four, Dewey Warren loses the football, battles for it. Oklahoma has recovered at the 32-yard line. Jim Files, the defensive right end from Fort Smith, Arkansas, number 84, stops the drive. First and 10, Oklahoma, and Kyle. Oklahoma has been pushed around defensively, but still leads the nation against the scoring play.
Well, that's a problem on that sprint option there. They either have to make up their mind quick, either to pitch it or to keep it. And that time, Dewey Warren was a little hesitant. Jim Files made a beautiful defensive play on it.
Now, for the first time, Oklahoma on offense. Bob Wormack, number 11, Eddie Hinton in motion, and the ball goes to the fullback. He goes straight ahead. Only that's the tailback, Ron Schatz, the senior. And we'll say right here now that it's going to be the tailback most of the night. Ron Schatz and Steve Owens, before tonight, have carried the ball 366 times between them. Their fullbacks, Mike Harper and Rick Baldridge, have carried the ball between them only 37 times all year long. Joe Killingsworth, number 83, the split end comes wide to the left. This is Wormack holding onto the ball across the line of scrimmage, across the 40, across the 45, and knocked out of bounds as he hits to the 48.5-yard line. Running him out of bounds was number 26, the All-American Albert Dorsey. But it's first down, Oklahoma.
And you know, Jim, to show you even further how little the fullback gets to carry the ball in the Oklahoma offensive philosophy, Wormack has carried the ball almost 100 times this season, and you combine that with the 366 times the other two tailbacks have carried it, and a fullback, if he weren't thick-skinned, could get an inferiority complex playing in that unit.
Now this time, Zabel, 82, has split left, and Killingsworth, 83, split right. Hinton, the slot back, and Wormack hands off to his tailback, Schatz again, and Schatz gets down to the 46-yard line. A pickup of about 5 yards. It'll be second down five. 11 minutes, 20 seconds to go. Bob Kalsu and Ken Mendenhall leading the way from their strong tackle and strong guard position. No score in this, the opening quarter.
What really makes this Oklahoma offensive unit go is Bob Wormack's ability to run, because they run just almost a power slant off of either tackle to their tailback, but whether Warmack keeps it or not is the big problem for the defensive unit.
Gillingsworth wide to the right. Warmack keeping the ball, and a couple of yards he gets inside the 45, down to the 43. Jim McDonald, the defensive right end from Knoxville, Tennessee, number 81, made the tackle. This 1968 Orange Bowl game comes to you from the Orange Bowl in Miami, Florida, live in color, exclusively on NBC, and in 70-degree weather. Ball is on the 43-yard line, third down, and 2 yards to go. 10.5 minutes left, first quarter, no score. Joe Killingsworth, the sophomore from Oklahoma City, drops out to the right. Warmack, and that shots again. Flag goes down as Schatz has the first down, but there's a flag down at the play at the 43. While we wait, as you can see, apparently Oklahoma is offside. You saw a list of our officials a little while ago. Now they're going the other way. They pointed toward Oklahoma, but Pete Williams is stepping it off against Tennessee. So it is offside Tennessee. In any event, Pete Williams of Miami, Florida, for those of you who follow service football, will remember what a great back he was at the Naval Academy in the late 40s. He is our referee tonight. First down inside the 40 at the 38-yard line of Tennessee. No score. Killingsworth wide right. Warmack faking the handoff. Now throwing. Has his man, Eddie Hinton, down to the 20-yard line, and out of bounds he goes. Another first down for Oklahoma.
The big problem, of course, for the Oklahoma linebackers, or rather the Tennessee linebackers, trying to figure out whether the tailback Schatz has that ball. Warmack is doing extremely good handing. There you see number 33, Eddie Hinton, going out. He was playing the slot man there. The linebacker had to come up to try to respect the run or the fake handoff to Ron Schatz. Wasn't in position to recover to defend against the pass.
First down from the 20. Warmack hands the shot. Schatz hit in the backfield and still manages to pick up yards across the 20 and down near the 17-yard line. Mike Jones, the safety man, number 11, a sophomore, made the stop. Jim McDonald, 81. Steve Carroll, 70. Jimmy Hahn, 58. Dick Williams, 74. Vic Dingus, 80. Across the front line for Tennessee, Jack Reynolds, 64. Jimmy Glover, 32. Steve Conner, 57, the linebackers. Jimmy Weatherford, 30. Mike Jones, 11. Albert Dorsey, the All-American, 26. Your deep men. Second and seven from the 18. Warmack looking. As Hinton, and Hinton turning, could not get his hands on it fully at the 11-yard line. The defender there was Albert Dorsey, number 26. Third down, seven, in the scoreless first quarter. 9 minutes, 23 seconds to go, and around the country, whether it is snowy or balmy as it is here in Miami, Florida, from NBC Sports, Happy New Year to you all. And if you're watching in color, what a brilliant show this is tonight in the Orange Bowl. Joe Killingsworth, 83, out to the left. Hinton is a flanker back, nearly with Killingsworth. In motion comes Schatz. Only one setback, and that's the fullback. Here's Warmack, looking and throwing. Has his man hit inside the 10-yard line. First down, Oklahoma. Mike Jones made the tackle, along with Albert Dorsey.
And we might mention, every time you see Ron Schatz, here we'll see that play again. There's Hinton, number 33, on that sprint-out option. Warmack just standing up and hitting him. We might mention, anytime you see this Ron Schatz, number 22, the tailback, go in motion, almost 95% of the time it will be a pass play.
Killingsworth wide to the right, first down and goal to go from the 7. Warmack faking the handoff, coming to the right, has running room. Hits for the end zone, touchdown!
Well, Jim, that's just like having a third running back. And here we'll see that play again. And look at that beautiful bootleg back behind his hip. And now he just outraces him into the corner.
6-0, Oklahoma on the fumble by Dewey Warren, deep in their own territory. Came back with Warmack completing 2 or 3 passes and running 7 yards for the score. Mike Bashan in to do the kicking. Warmack to hold. And the kick is good. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Oklahoma 7, Tennessee nothing.
Wouldn't it be nice if you could take every bottle of Coca-Cola that you'll be having for the next 10 years and put them right here, just like this? And every time you opened a bottle, it would be icy cold, refreshing, and delicious. Well, that's the great thing about Coca-Cola. Every drink is refreshing and delicious, whether it's in an icy mountain stream or your refrigerator right at home. When you open a bottle of Coca-Cola, you can be sure of one thing. Coca-Cola has the taste you never get tired of. That's why things go better with Coke after Coke after Coke. So next time you come up thirsty, remember, Coca-Cola always tastes just the way this looks right now.
Jim Simpson with Kyle Road. Before an estimated 77,900 fans, Oklahoma has taken the lead in the first quarter. Mike Vachon will kick off to Bill Battle. And Charlie Fulton. And he really kicks off. Fulton takes it in the end zone and decides to stay right there. First and 10, Tennessee on the 20. Tennessee took the opening kickoff and marched deep into Oklahoma territory. Warren fumbled. It was recovered by Jim Files of Oklahoma, and Warmack put him on the war path, and it is 7-0 Oklahoma.
We might point out one additional factor that will play an important role tonight. Each team has senior players who, I'm sure right at this moment, realize more than ever that they're playing their last game for their respective schools. A bit sad for them, but I'm sure a source of inspiration, too.
Gary Dalton out to the left, Richmond Flowers to the right. Dewey Warren carrying the ball and picks up 6 yards out to the 26-yard line. The quarterback, and in talking to him, Rick Goodwin, the left side linebacker, made the stop along with Dick Peso, the left tackle. But in talking to Dewey Warren, he was asked by the press many times, would you rather run or throw? Tonight, thus far, Kyle, Warren has run more than he's thrown, and he said he'd rather throw. Second down, 4 from the 26, 7-0 Oklahoma, 8:10 to go, still in the first quarter. Dalton, wide right, Bowers to the left. Warren pitching out again to Charlie Fulton. He's got speed, but down he goes as he gets back to the 27-yard line. And that is Rick Goodwin. Goodwin, the senior from Tampa, Texas, 5'9", 194, the left side linebacker who made the tackle. It'll be third down and a long 3. They've got to get to the 30 for the first down. Number 17 in your picture is Bruce Stensrud. Number 81 there is John Kohler. 79, Dick Peso. 43 in the middle is the monster, or rather the linebacker, Don Primmer, on a big play for Tennessee. Third and a long 3. Warren. Warren passes and overshoots his man, almost intercepted by Bruce Stensrud, number 17. It's fourth down and 3. Intended for DeLong, who trots off the field along with Dewey Warren. The numbers 2 and 3 teams in the country. Tennessee, beaten only in its opening game by UCLA. And Oklahoma, beaten only by Texas. Back deep goes Eddie Hinton. Bruce Stensrud is up close. One of the up men as the kicker Herman Weaver comes in. Weaver gets a very short kickoff. Fair catch called for by number 31, Bobby Stevenson, the senior from Claremont, California, at the 44-yard line of Oklahoma, where the Sooners, leading 7-0, will put the ball in play. So action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score is Oklahoma 7 and Tennessee nothing.
Remember when cars had fenders that stuck out like this? And running boards like this? And funny-looking bumpers like this? Though some cars are still pretty old-fashioned looking. Now, this is the most old-fashioned car we make. A Pontiac Tempest. Under here, 175 horsepower overhead cam engine that moves on regular gas. In here, enough room for what it takes two of those to handle, and yet it's wide track, takes curves like a sports car. It doesn't make much sense to spend your time driving one of those when you could be driving one of these, especially now during Pontiac's comparison sale. Think about it.
From the 44-yard line of Oklahoma, the Sooners, leading 7-0, will put the ball in play. A tremendous crowd on a colorful night, the third game of our NBC's New Year's Day triple-header. Joe Killingsworth, number 83, trots out to the right. Oklahoma's functioned all year without a major injury. They stay pretty constant in their lineups. And there again is their tailback, Steve Owens, who has come in for the first time. He's a sophomore from Miami, Oklahoma, who led the Big Eight in rushing, and they think the world of him. Steve Carroll, the sophomore right tackle from Chattanooga, number 7, he made the stop.
And that is a companion play to the pitch out to Eddie Hinton coming around in motion. They hand it off to the tailback on that play, but there is also the option where Warmack can keep it, fake it to Schatz, and pitch it out to Eddie Hinton.
Second and 8, Zabel is to the left, Hinton and Killingsworth to the right. Warmack sprinting to his right. Blocker in front of him, aims and has Hinton all by himself, and he steps out of bounds on the 37-yard line of Tennessee. First down, Oklahoma. Tennessee was favored by most in this football game, but thus far, it has been Oklahoma. But may we remind you that, for example, in the Sugar Bowl, Wyoming led at the half 13-0, and LSU came back to win 20-13. In the Rose Bowl, USC 14, Indiana 3. In the Cotton Bowl, Texas A&M 20, Alabama 16. First down from the 37. Warmack keeping the ball, hiding it nicely. Hinton again, and he drops the ball. Incomplete pass. Being pursued there by Mike Jones, number 11, a sophomore from Nashville who was a quarterback until Bill Young, their regular safety man, got hurt in fall practice, and Mike stepped in as a safety man and has been there ever since, number 11.
And what a fine job Mike Jones has done. 7 interceptions for a total return of 150 yards. And as you mentioned, Jim, just a sophomore.
Well, that 150-yard return, Kyle, to stay on the subject of number 11, Mike Jones, is a new Tennessee record. And with the 7 interceptions, he not only led the team, but the Southeastern Conference. Killingsworth left. On second down, Warmack, for the first time, dropping straight back. Firing it into a crowd, it is incomplete across the way with the intended receiver, Steve Zabel, the sophomore from Thornton, Colorado, number 82. Zabel is a tight end but has great hands, and they throw to him a lot. 22 catches this year for 3 touchdowns. Only Eddie Hinton had more catches, 28. Now from the 37 of Tennessee, Warmack is now 3 for 6. It's third down and 10. That's Hinton taking a different stance out there to the left. Warmack dropping straight back again. Now throwing a swing pass to Steve Owens. Owens is in a crowd and does not have the first down. Inside the 35, down to the 34. Tackle was made again by Steve Carroll, a sophomore from Chattanooga.
We might mention Steve Owens, number 36, who just caught that screen pass. Just a sophomore also. They have a number of fine ones on this Oklahoma team. He and Ron Schatz, can you imagine the combination of two tailbacks that have gained the yardage these two fellows have? Schatz, 726 yards for the season. Steve Owens, who's averaged a little over 4 yards per carry, led the team with 808 yards during the season.
Gordon Wheeler, 19th in the country in punting, and Oklahoma, I believe, has taken too much time. On fourth down, Wheeler came in to do the kicking. That'll take him from the 34 back to the 39. That'll be fourth down again. 7-0, Oklahoma leading. We've got 5 minutes and 41 seconds to go in this exciting first quarter of the Orange Bowl. 40-yard average for Gordon Wheeler as Mike Jones again goes deep, number 11. High snap and kicks a beauty, but this will go deep into the end zone, out of the end zone, and does not bounce into the stands. That was the only question. So the ball will come out to the 20-yard line, first and 10 for Tennessee. Now, besides this New Year's Day triple header, and this is the third game of it, remember, we'll telecast 2 other outstanding postseason games. Next Saturday, January the 6th, starting at 2 o'clock Eastern Time, the Senior Bowl from Mobile, Alabama, with the top players from the North against the best of the South. Then on Sunday, January 21st, starting at 1:30 Eastern Standard Time, The American Football League All-Star Game, the top AFL Eastern Division players against the best of the West. Two more outstanding postseason games in color, exclusively on NBC. Dewey Warden calling signals from the 20. Hands to his tailback, Chadwick, who almost lost the ball, but gets the first down out to the 39. Bruce Stenfrud made the tackle. Chadwick, who has had trouble fumbling this year, almost lost it. But he's their leading scorer, and here he comes.
And watch that block by Bob Johnson on Granville Liggins. Actually, it was one of those sucker type of plays where Johnson blocked him as though they were trying to go to the right side. And Chadwick made a beautiful move, cut back off to the left, and actually Johnson didn't have to block him too hard.
7-0 Oklahoma. Richmond Flowers to the right. Ball at the 39. Quick pitch to Chadwick again. Chadwick this time is knocked down hard. Setting up is Dick Peso, along with John Titsworth. It was Titsworth who made the tackle on the right side there. The junior from Oklahoma, 6'3", 215, number 78.
We might mention, while you're watching them line up, keep your eye on that middle guard on defense for Oklahoma, number 66, Granville Liggins. And watch to see how fast they can get and attack that offensive line, because this is going to be a big factor in who wins this ball game tonight.
Second down and 9, and Warren drops straight back. Warren fires to Charlie Fulton. Fulton has great speed, and Fulton is out to midfield and near the first down. If they mark the ball at midfield, it will be a first down. And it is a first down for Tennessee, Charlie Fulton. Fulton, as we said, has played everywhere in this backfield this year, all four positions. 69 carries, almost a 5-yard average. 5'10", 180, a senior from Memphis, Tennessee. Richmond Flowers, who hopes to compete in the Olympics next year, number 22, goes to the left. Dewey Warren with the ball on his hip. Going long to Flowers. Back there is Barrett, along with number 31, Bob Stevenson. And 35, Barrett in your picture right there, is the junior safety man, and a good one. But he fell on his ankle last Wednesday in practice, and the question was, what kind of speed was he going to have tonight? Second down and 10.
With Dewey Warren operating this Tennessee offense, for those of you interested in statistics, in 1965, he completed 55% of his passes, and in the last two seasons, 66 and 67, an amazing, Jim, at least I think, 59% of his passes.
Bill Baker is in, resting Richmond Flowers as wingback. Baker, a junior from Jasper, Tennessee, number 48. He is flanked left. Dewey Warden hands the ball to Pickens, his fullback, who picks up a couple of yards to the 48 of Oklahoma. 3 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the first quarter. 7-0. The Sooners lead the Volunteers. Third down.
Here is Bob Johnson centering there, blocking on. There you see a beautiful block put on Granville Liggins on that draw play.
And that, as Kyler said, is what everybody's here to watch tonight. A lot of them realizing that Johnson is an All-American center, 54. Liggins, an All-American middle guard, 66. Here's Warren on third down, firing and overshoots his man. Downfield was number 91, Gary Chris, a sophomore from Oliver Springs, Tennessee, number 91.
And to show you the respect that Tennessee has for Oklahoma's Granville Liggins, they put two men on him. You'll see the two men, the center and the right guard. The right guard, Charlie Rosenfelder. And when you have two men on you in that line, Jim, you can't expect to get through too often.
Herman Weaver in to do the punting. Warren is 2 for 5 in the passing department. Eddie Hinton is deep. High kick. Hinton calling for the fair catch inside the 15 at the 13, where it'll be first and 10 for Oklahoma. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score is Oklahoma 7, Tennessee nothing. And now we return to our studios for this commercial message.
Come on, girl.
I think she's getting tired.
My taste is pretty tired after that last cigarette.
Try mine.
Now, what's so special
about it? They're different. Tastes great. Go ahead. Have a Salem.
Have a Salem. See how Salem.
Wait a minute. Stop and think. Is your taste tired out? Does your cigarette have that worn-out 4 o'clock taste? If your cigarette has that 4 o'clock taste, now's the time for Salem, America's best-selling menthol.
and springtime fresh. That's the taste you get from Salem.
Say, that's a good tasting cigarette.
That's a Salem filter cigarette. Salem, America's largest selling menthol. Because Salem refreshes your taste.
On this first day of 1968, Jim Simpson, along with Kyle Rote, 70 degrees the temperature in Miami, Florida, for the 34th renewal of the Orange Bowl. 7-0 the score, first and 10 for Oklahoma, who leads from its own 13. Killingsworth comes wide to the left. There's the tailback once more, and Ron Schatz gets a couple of yards out across the 15 to the 17. Make it a pickup of 4. It is second down 6.
And always keep in mind on that play, that fullback, or rather tailback slant, that Bob Warmack is more inclined to keep that ball than to hand it off. And this is what's concerning Tennessee right now, too.
Warmack carried the ball 98 times this year himself, which is a whale of a lot for a quarterback. Second and 6. Warmack sprinting out, being chased, getting the ball away, but he was really being chased by Steve Kerner, the sophomore from Tampa, Florida. Weatherford broke up the pass intended for Hinton, but that was Steve Kerner blitzing in from the right side. Third down and 6. 2:03 left, first quarter. Before the largest crowd ever in the Orange Bowl. Oklahoma played Duke. Oklahoma played Maryland. They were the previous record crowd, 76,000 plus. This is 77,000 plus. Gillingsworth to the left. Zabel to the right. Third and 6. Big play for both teams. Warmack with time fires the ball and has the man across the way, and he has got the first down. Out across the 25 to the 27-yard line. Getting up, that is Zabel. Steve Zabel, the tight end and sophomore. This is the Sooner band of OU. And around the city of Miami, you can see a lot of supporters of both schools, Tennessee and Oklahoma. Gillingsworth coming out to the left. Zabel, the tight end, splits to the right. That's Hinton set in the slot. On first down from the 27, again, it is the tailback, Ron Schatz. And if you were not with us from the outset, we'll say one more time that Schatz and Owens, as tailbacks, carried the ball 366 times before tonight. The fullbacks combined only 37 carries. Steve Carroll, the sophomore right tackle, has been having a great night. Again, made the tackle, number 7.
And with all of that slant, tailback slant running that they're doing, tremendous burden on these two tackles, Bob Chalsu and Byron Bigby, the offensive tackles, as well as the guards, Ed Lancaster and Ken Mendenhall.
Second down and 6. Warmack keeps the ball, cuts inside, has the first down, gets around two men across the 40-yard line. Jones is after him, ducks under Jones, and he's finally dragged down by Albert Dorsey. First down at the 32-yard line of Tennessee with 30 seconds to go in the first quarter. And there's the Oklahoma rooting section, and there's Bob Warmack, the junior from Ada, Oklahoma. And according to Bob the other day, in Ada, they raise nothing but championship high school football teams, and that's where he plays.
And here we see that play again, Bob Warmack, and there you see trailing back behind him, his flanker back, Eddie Hinton. He faked the pitch out, cut back, and now reversing his field, coming in to make the tackle, Mike Jones, and Jack Reynolds finally pulling him down.
Now back live, Warmack back to throw, has his man inside the 30-yard line. Weatherford made the stop of Mike Harper, the fullback, as time has run out here in the first quarter. That's the end of the first quarter in this 1968 Orange Bowl game with the score, Oklahoma 7, Tennessee nothing.
Would you like to go on a ski lift holiday? Let's grab some sky, you and I. Let's fly on a singing, swinging ski lift holiday.
Grab some sky on a United Airlines ski lift holiday. You don't even have to ski to have yourself a snowball of a time. Get away from it all on a United Airlines ski lift holiday.
Let's fly on a singing, swinging ski lift holiday. Final friendly day.
away from it all on a United Ski Lift holiday. All you need to ski and fly is a free United credit card.
Ball is on the 28-yard line of Tennessee. Bob Wormack, they call him the Worm, just wormed his way for a 38-yard run. Schatz has carried the ball for Oklahoma six times and gained 26 yards. Warren of Tennessee, trying to get the Tennessee team on track offensively, is 2 for 5. 7-0 to score as we begin the second quarter. The Oklahoma coaches felt they had a chance to upset Tennessee if Bob Wormack had a whale of a night. Thus far, he is having that kind of evening. Now Hinton and Killingsworth both go to the left. Zabel split to the right. Second and 7. Ball is handed to Ron Schatz. Schatz is down to the 21-yard line. Before he's dragged down there by the left side linebacker Jack Reynolds, number 64, and Frank Yannesy, number 79, also in on the tack. But that is a first down for Oklahoma at the 21-yard line. Byron Bigby and Ed Lancaster, the weak side tackle and guard, opened up a big hole over the left side of the Tennessee line. First and 10 from just over the 20. Hinton and Killingsworth again wide left. Wormack fakes the handoff. Back, throws it long. Indians up for Hinton. Touchdown!
And here we see him in the slot position, coming off behind Killingsworth, back into the corner. Number 32, Jimmy Glover, trying to defend on the play. Eddie Hinton, a 9-7 sprinter.
And now, Mike Vachon is in the kick, and Wormack, having this great night, is holding. Vachon's kick is no good off to the side. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Oklahoma 13 and Tennessee nothing.
Hey, mister. Want a savings suggestion? When you're paying your monthly bills, did you ever think of paying yourself? Sure. What you have to do is decide how much you want to save. 5% of your take-home pay is about average. Then each month, write out a check for that amount and put it into your savings account at your Savings and Loan Association. Why a savings and loan? Because they're the specialists in saving. Over the years, they've paid better returns on savings than any other type of financial institution. So, this month, every month, when you sit down to pay your bills, don't forget old number one. Pay yourself first. A savings suggestion from your savings and loan. Where you save does make a difference.
Vachon will kick off, 13-0 the score, battle 48. And Charlie Fulton deep for the thus far stunned Volunteers of Tennessee, the Southeastern Conference champions. And that is Fulton, and he is going to bring it out across the 10. Great speed across the 20, he's already made it. Breaks loose at the 30. Down the sidelines he goes. Cuts inside and down to the 39-yard line of Oklahoma. With Cagle, Dean Cagle, and Don Primmer making the stop. And now Tennessee gets its turn to cheer.
Here we see Charlie Fulton heading up to the right side. And he's going to pick up a great block here by Terry Dalton, number 86. Right there.
Well, the experts said this could be one of the highest scoring Orange Bowl games in history. We shall see. Dalton comes to the left. From the 39 of Oklahoma, Fulton is in at quarterback and hands the ball off to Chadwick, his tailback. Dewey Warren has been replaced for the moment by Fulton, who just returned that kickoff and has been playing tailback until now. The ball is on the 34-yard line. It'll be second down and 5. Young coaches Doug Dickey, 35, of Tennessee. Chuck Fairbanks, 34, of Oklahoma. Golden keeping the ball again. He prefers to run with the ball and is down near the 30-yard line and about a yard and a half shy of a first down. Granville Liggins and John Kohler made the tackle.
Incidentally, Jim, we have two perfect lines on the record tonight. Tennessee's tailback, Walter Chadwick, number 20, has thrown two passes this season, both of them complete, and both of them completed for touchdowns. Oklahoma's defensive halfback, Bob Stevenson, has intercepted two passes this season, returned both of them for touchdowns.
Dalton to the left. Fulton hands off to Chadwick, who has the first down down to the 26-yard line of Oklahoma. Walter Chadwick diving over Granville Liggins for the first down. 13-0 is the score. Oklahoma over Tennessee. We're in the second quarter, 12 minutes and 40 seconds left. Largest crowd ever in the history of the Orange Bowl, which dates back now 34 years. Richmond Flowers, 22 out to the right. Dalton, 86, comes left. Holden hands to Chadwick again, and Chadwick is bounced back by Rick Goodwin, the left side linebacker, number 52, from Tampa, Texas. It's down to the 25-yard line. A gain of about two. It is second down eight. Other games today, the Sugar Bowl, LSU 20, Wyoming 13, Cotton Bowl, Texas A&M 20, Alabama 16. Rose Bowl, number one, USC 14, Indiana 3, O.J. Simpson had a great day. And Indiana played very well. Louis Warren back in at quarterback, handing to his fullback, number 34, Richard Pickens, but Granville Liggins has a hold of him, number 66. And there's a loss on the play. Third down and about nine. Now Fulton comes in, and let's see whether Warren goes out or whether a tailback goes out. Chadwick goes out, so Fulton is now coming in, and you can see the versatility of Charlie now. He'll take over at tailback. This 1968 Orange Bowl game comes to you from the Orange Bowl in Miami, Florida, live in color exclusively on NBC. Third and nine from the 26th of Oklahoma. Warren, a fine passer, in trouble, dragged down at the 34-yard line. And look who's getting up. Number 78, John Kitsworth, and number 66, Granville Liggins, the senior from Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Now let's watch that again from a defensive standpoint. Granville Liggins, number 66. The All-America from Oklahoma. Might say Lawton, Oklahoma, I believe.
Joey Grayson has come into the defensive secondary. And now, Carl Kremser, born in Germany, never kicked a football before February of this year, but quite a field goal kicker now, will try one from the 41. This means a 51-yard field goal attempt. He's got a lot of foot, but not enough for this kick. As the ball goes into the end zone, it will roll dead there, and Oklahoma will take over first and 10 on its own 20. So, action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Oklahoma 13 and Tennessee nothing.
Watch Fran Tarkenton, daring quarterback of the New York Giants. What makes a great competitor like Fran Tarkenton?
He's got to be tough, both mentally and physically. And, of course, he's got to have a great desire to win.
And, Fran, what makes a great shave?
Well, I think it's the lather. That's why I use Rise. Rise lets me shave fast, shave close, without irritation.
Here's why. Rise is so rich, so wet, it doesn't dry out on your face. Instead, it stays moist and creamy. Keeps whiskers wet and soft all through your shave. Here's why. See how Rise, with millions of tiny moisture-packed bubbles, soaks whiskers soft, keeps whiskers wet and soft, so you cut them off at the skin line. You shave fast, shave close, without irritation.
So if you want to shave fast, shave close, without irritation, shave with Rise, a really great lather.
Rise regular or refreshing Rise menthol.
Over 77,000 are here tonight, including Governor and Mrs. Claude Kirk of Florida, in the press box there with the Orange Bowl President Bill Landtaff and Mrs. Landtaff. And the girl there is Miss Sally Sherman, who is Disneyland's 1968 ambassador to the world. From the 20, first and 10, Oklahoma. Longest field goal, 36 yards, 1964, between Nebraska and Auburn here. And, of course, Kremser just tried one from 51 yards. It failed. Warmack in. holding the ball on his hip, being chased, in trouble for the first time tonight, and down he goes. Inside the 20, at the 18-yard line. Carroll was the man who ran him out of bounds. And also over there was number 87, Neil McMeans, a junior left end from Gate City, Virginia.
And Jim, before we get the people in Tulsa, Oklahoma, too mad at us, Granville Liggins is from Tulsa, Oklahoma, not Lawton.
Gillingsworth goes out wide to the left. I believe I told you, Oklahoma has functioned all year long without a major injury. Not one regular has ever missed a game, offense or defense. Incredible. Tennessee's been hurt a lot, but has great depth. There is Steve Owens. Owens gets back the 2 yards lost on the last play, plus five more out to the 25. It'll be third and five. Tackle was made by Steve Kiner of Tampa, Florida. The right side linebacker voted the best sophomore in the Southeastern Conference.
And it might seem a little difficult to screen off of this I formation, although it really isn't. Oklahoma, when they screen, they will go through their slot line, usually Eddie Hinton when he's in the slot, as he is now.
Third down five. Warmack has set up one touchdown and thrown for another. Now with the ball, being pursued and dragged down, that is Jack Reynolds and Steve Kiner, the two linebackers, 64, 57, along with Neil McMeans, 87. Warmack has run 7 yards for a touchdown back in the first quarter and thrown 21 yards to Ed Hinton for a second score. Loss on the play back to the 21, and that brings up fourth down and nine. 13 to nothing as you look back now at the deep man, who is Baker. Bill Baker, the junior from Jasper, Tennessee. In to do the kicking is Gordon Wheeler. Wheeler kicks from his own 12 and hits one high. Baker fading back inside his 30 to the 28. Downfield, Oklahoma very quickly and swarming down at the 30-yard line. Setting up is Byron Bigby, the weak side tackle number 73. Now, don't forget those two NBC Golf exclusives coming up next month in February. The Bob Hope Desert Classic from Palm Desert, California, followed 1 week later by the Andy Williams Golf Tournament from the Torrey Pines Golf Course in San Diego. And then in March, a special golf tournament from the La Costa Country Club. And we'll be telling you more about that one in the weeks to come. Golf on NBC, a very special thing. Tennessee trailing by two touchdowns. Fulton again in as the quarterback hands to Chadwick, who gets 5 yards out to the 35. Warren now coming in. Eight minutes, 53 seconds with the clock running here in the second quarter. Richmond Flowers coming out to the left, number 22. That is Fulton still at quarterback. And that is Chadwick with the ball across the 40 and out to the 49-yard line. First down for Tennessee as they try to get back in this ball game. Walter Chadwick is a senior playing his last game from Decatur, Georgia. Kyle told you he's thrown two passes, both for touchdowns, one against Ole Miss, the other against Alabama. The leading scorer for Tennessee was 66 points and 11 touchdowns. The leading rusher with 671 yards and a 4.5-yard average. He twisted his ankle after the season playing basketball, but obviously is all right now. First down, Tennessee trying to get on the scoreboard. Fulton remains in, has the ball, throws, and this will be intercepted by number 17, Bruce Stenfrew. Stenfrew knocked down at the 26-yard line by Gary Crisp, the split end. First and 10 for the Sooners of Oklahoma, who thus far, Kyle wrote, have controlled the ballgame.
I mean, it'll be just a matter of time, at least from our viewpoint up here, watching Richmond Flowers flank out here. They probably won't go to Flowers too much because every time he flanks out, they put Gary Harper on him. And this, I'm sure, Richmond Flowers gets double covered in almost every game he goes into, I'm sure it's discouraging the Tennessee quarterback from throwing to him.
Five All-Americans are playing in this ball game, and there goes Ron Schott. All-Southeastern Conference, second leading rusher in the Big Eight, out to the 32-yard line.
a pickup of 6 yards. It'll be second down and 4. 7.5 minutes left, 13 to nothing. Jack Reynolds, a sophomore linebacker from Cincinnati, number 64 on the left side, made the stop. On the near side, of course, is the Oklahoma Cut coach, Chuck Fairbanks. As Wormack hands off again to Ron Schatz, who gets out across the 35 to the 37. And he's close, if not, to the first down. First down for Oklahoma.
And this has been the difference thus far, Jim. The getting off the ball by this Oklahoma offensive line. They, up to this point, have been handling the Tennessee defensive line pretty well. And they've been creating some tremendous holes, as you have pointed out. Byron Bigby, the right tackle. Bob Galsu, the other tackle. Ken Mendenhall and Ed Lancaster, of course, the center, Bob Gray.
Zabel to the right, Gillingsworth to the left, and Hinton slot left. And here goes Schatz again, and Schatz is out to the 40-yard line, maybe the 41. Oklahoma has 8 first downs, Tennessee 6, but the score reads 13-0, Oklahoma. Second down, and 7 to go. Halftime, of course, we've got the Oklahoma band, the Tennessee band, and an Ernie Siler special, our pageant, Orange Bowl pageant at halftime. Gillingsworth to the left. Oklahoma making few, if any, substitutions. Wormack on a jump pass. The ball is in the air. Belongs to anybody, but it is no good. It was intended for Eddie Hinton. And it looked like it was knocked in the air by Jack Reynolds, who, like Steve Carroll, and they're both sophomores, played a tremendous game thus far tonight. First down, as you can see, for interference on the play charged against Tennessee. Oh, it is first down at the 45.
It's difficult for the Oklahoma, or rather Tennessee man, not to interfere there because Wormack had made a beautiful fake to his fullback and looked for all purposes like a running play.
Zabel right, Gillingsworth left. Wormack now 6 for 12, hands the ball off, and down goes Schatz. He may have gotten 6 or 7 inches and no more. Steve Carroll, you'll find down at the bottom of that pile, along with Jack Reynolds once more. Those two have combined on a number of tackles. 5 minutes, 45 seconds left to go in the half. Oklahoma scored with 8 minutes and 39 seconds left in the first quarter on a 7-yard run by Wormack into the corner. And then in the second quarter, at the very outset, within the first minute, on a 21-yard pass from Wormack to Hinton. And that's where we stand. Zabel to the left, Gillingsworth to the right. Wormack still has the ball. As his man Hinton gets past Jones, dragged down by Albert Dorsey, but not until he's got the first down inside the 35, down to the 33-yard line of Tennessee. Owens comes in for Schatz. There is Eddie Hinton, and here he is again, Kyle.
And here is Bob Wormack, number 11, and he makes some beautiful faking in that backfield. And there you see number 33, Eddie Hinton, going across field, eluding number 11, Mike Jones, finally brought down by Albert Darcy.
Tennessee, number 2 in the country. Oklahoma, number 3. Wormack on a quick count. Holds on to the ball, fakes the pitch back. Jack Reynolds makes the stop after he gets inside the 30. Another long game for Bob Wormack, the junior from Ada, Oklahoma. The leading pass receiver in Orange Bowl history was an Alabama boy by the name of Ray Perkins, now with the Baltimore Colts. He caught 9. Hinton has already caught 5. And there's Wormack's record, 7 for 13. Second and 3. And that is Owen vaulting for the first down. Carroll down at the bottom, but Steve Owen simply went over the top. And it's first down, Oklahoma.
And you know, we talked about Dewey Warren's pass completion percentage of being 59%. Bob Wormack doesn't do bad in that department himself. This season, 53% of his passes completed.
Tennessee, their third consecutive year in a bowl game under young Doug Dickey. They won the other two in the blue bonnet and in the gator, and now they're trailing Oklahoma. That is Hinton in motion. Wormack still has the ball, going for his fullback, and he holds on to it. That is Mike Harper, a sophomore from Jenks, Oklahoma, and there's quite a story there. Harper came up as a sophomore. His brother Gary, a junior, was the fullback a year ago. But Mike ran him out of a job, and so Gary now contents himself as a monster man. Second down and six. 3 minutes, 40 seconds to go. First half. 13-0 Oklahoma in this pageant as you look from the Orange Bowl end zone, where there's a huge Statue of Liberty. Wormack keeping the ball inside the 10, down to the 8-yard line. He's got another first down. And Bob Wormack, they call him the Worm, is having a great night. And I'm sorry for the pun, child, but I got to say the Worm has turned.
You know, as we mentioned earlier, the pressure on these linebackers, whether to try and come in for the quarterback or look out there for the pitch shot as he sprints down the line with that option. With Wormack, I think you're better just concentrating on him for a while.
Gillingsworth out to the left. From the 8-yard line, there is Owens, who's down near the 5 and is gang-tackled by Tennessee there. I'm sure in the great Southwest, folks are quite happy at the 13-0 score, but I'm sure in the Southeast, there are many who are not so happy at Tennessee being on the short end of the score. For both, we remind that the score at the halftime of a great Sugar Bowl game today on NBC was Wyoming 13 and LSU nothing in the final. It was LSU 20, Wyoming 13. I say that only to prove that anything can and does happen in football. From the 5-yard line, second down and goal to go. There goes Owens, and he's down near the goal line. And if he is shy, which they say he is, he's not shy by much. It'll be third down and that far to go. Here's something interesting, Kyle, because the fullback, normally the man many teams call on in this situation, hardly ever carries the ball in the Oklahoma offense. Let's see what happens.
Well, with the way their tackles and guards are driving out off of that ball, it really doesn't make much difference, I think, at this point.
They give it to Owens. Touchdown. And the coaching staff at Norman, Oklahoma feels that this sophomore from Miami of Oklahoma will be a great one. There he is scoring again in the surprising Orange Bowl game. Not surprising that Oklahoma is out in front, but by the amount of points they have managed to stack up here in the first half. 19-0 right now. And Little Red, the Indian, is quite happy. Oklahoma's band will be first on the field at halftime, followed by Tennessee, and then our Orange Bowl pageant.
And Jim, you know, we've talked about and used so many superlatives connected with the players. What an outstanding job these two coaches in tonight's game have been doing. Doug Dickey of the second-ranked Tennessee team, named Southeastern Conference Coach of the Year. Oklahoma's rookie coach, Chuck Fairbanks, leading Oklahoma to its best season in 9 years. This is, incidentally, Dickey's third bowl game. They beat Tulsa in the Blue Bonnet Bowl in 1965. They beat Syracuse in the Gator Bowl in 1966. And tonight, they're a little behind.
That's Dickey right now, and you can tell which one he is because Coach Dickey has his hands on his hips. That's Richmond Flowers alongside of him. On Friday, January the 12th, be sure to see the nighttime premiere of NBC's hilarious game show, The Hollywood Squares. Wally Cox, Charlie Weaver, Abby Dalton, and the whole gang will be there, along with host Peter Marshall. Join them on The Hollywood Squares, premiering Friday, January 12th at 9:30, 8:30 Central Time, here on NBC. That is young Chuck Fairbanks, the coach who took over after the tragic death of Jim McKenzie last spring, and has guided this team to a 9-1 record and a 19-0 lead over Tennessee in the Orange Bowl. And a young team of sophomores and juniors.
And honored as the freshman coach of the year, I believe, or rookie coach, whatever they call it, among all of the first-year coaches in the country at major colleges.
Having missed an extra point, Oklahoma now chooses to go for two on this particular touchdown. There's Wormack fading one, and there's Harper, his fullback, for the 2 points. And Oklahoma jumps out in front by the score of 21-0. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl, and hold on as there's a flag. Hold on, there's a flag down at the 3. Pete Williams has come in. The referee has the football. And obviously it is against Oklahoma, or else they would have refused. That is marching off 5 yards. or legal motion on the play. Now Warmack is staring over at Coach Fairbanks to see whether or not he should still go for the two. Fairbanks has turned his back on him. And they've decided to go for the two once more. Billingsworth coming out to the right. Hinton coming out to the right. Zabel is on the left side. In motion, that is Owens, and as Kyle told you, that usually means a pass, and that's exactly what they're going to do. But all the time in the world, and now he's run out of time. Warmack on the move, and does not get it. Just knocked down across the way. Nick Showalter, number 88, over there to knock him down. A junior defensive end from Kingsport, Tennessee. And so the conversion attempt is no good. A minute and 48 seconds left to go in the first half before more than 77,000 at the Orange Bowl. Warmack has carried the ball seven times for 41 yards and is 8 for 14 as a passer. Scored once on a 7-yard run, thrown a touchdown pass to Eddie Hinton of 21 yards, and of course Steve Owens has just scored the third touchdown from the 1-foot line. Statue of Liberty, which drew a round of applause. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Oklahoma 19 and Tennessee nothing.
Right now, your Pontiac dealer is having a comparison sale. All right, let's compare sports cars. This is Pontiac's exciting new Firebird with its unique 175-horsepower overhead cam engine. Beautiful, isn't it? And these are its toughest competition, four of the best sports cars in the world. They all have bucket seats, road-hugging suspension, and even I have to admit, they look fantastic. Now, this has a high-compression overhead cam engine. Regular gas V8, high-output V8, and this one has just about everything you can put on a sports car. That's pretty rough competition, right? You know it. They're all Firebirds. Pontiac Firebirds. With competition like this, who needs those other sports cars?
Jim Simpson with Kyle Rode at the Orange Bowl as Vachon will kick off again, a low kick this time. Richmond Flowers is there. He is the Olympic hurdle prospect, remember, as great speed, but down he goes. With number 17, Bruce Denfrew, a sophomore from Dallas, Texas, putting the tackle on him inside the 25, down, well, a market just at the 20. We pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC television network. One minute, 43 seconds left. First half. Oklahoma has stunned the partisan crowd of Tennessee fans across the way, and I'm sure around the country. Chris comes out to the left, the split end. Running out with the ball is Dewey Warren. Warren passing and over the head of the monster man, Gary Harper. It was intended for Gary Chris, the Oliver Springs, Tennessee sophomore, number 91.
A good pass defense on the part of Oklahoma's Bob Stevenson and Gary Harper, number 45, who, as you aptly call him, the monster man, moves around to the strength of the formation. And it's one of the unique positions. He has to be somewhere in between a linebacker and a defensive halfback physically, strong enough to come up and meet the run, agile enough to drop back into pass coverage.
Linebacker stepping in. Pass over the middle and caught. And Richmond Flowers had his knee hit the ground, and that's why he simply stopped as he did. But it's a first down with a minute and 25 seconds showing, and the Volunteers try to get on the scoreboard. And Tennessee has called timeout, Kyle.
And here we see Flowers, number 22, going downfield, just bending across the middle, catching the Oklahoma defensive unit into a zone.
One minute, 23 seconds to go as they're marking time on the field. And action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Oklahoma 19, Tennessee nothing.
Our name. well done.
Frank, get your Frank hot dog. Hot dog, get your Frank hot dog. Frank.
When we came on the air, we said the temperature was 70. We have since checked once more, and it is 72 degrees. Chris to the left, Flowers to the right. Dewey Warren dropping back. Lots of time. Sending it long downfield, and it is intercepted by Steve Barrett. There's the junior from Artesia, New Mexico, that we told you was hurt. It was intended for Kenny DeLong, as Barrett was in a practice last Wednesday at the Miami field and suffered an ankle injury, and they were questionable whether or not he would play tonight. He has, and he is intercepted. That is his seventh interception of the year. The ball is on the 7-yard line, and again, Oklahoma has come up with a big play, and Warmack trots into your picture now. 1 minute, 14 seconds left. 19-0, Oklahoma. And now Oklahoma is going to call timeout. The Sugar Bowl today, Wyoming led at halftime 13-0, but LSU beat them 20-13, and Wyoming was threatening as the gun went off down inside the 5. The Rose Bowl, with O.J. Simpson having a great day, defeated Indiana. Indiana University held in there but lost 14-3. Cotton Bowl, Texas A&M, as the pupil Gene Stallings beat the teacher Paul Bear Bryant 20-16 over Alabama. Don't forget, following tonight's Orange Bowl game, to stay tuned for Bowl Day 68. It's Pat Hernan for highlights of all of those actions of the Rose Bowl, the Sugar Bowl, the Cotton Bowl, and, of course, this game, the Orange Bowl. That's Bowl Day 68, immediately following, in color and exclusively on NBC. Ball is on the 7-yard line, first down 10. And what a sight. The Orange Bowl in Miami, record crowd. Oklahoma, this is their seventh appearance in the Orange Bowl. They've won 4 and lost 2. Warmack hands off to his tailback, Steve Owens, who gets out across the 10. And again, time is called by Tennessee this time, Kyle, as they would like to get the ball with some time left.
Well, obviously, with the time running out there, they must conserve it, hopefully to stop Oklahoma in downs and force them into a punting situation. And Oklahoma's punter, although he hasn't gotten off any tremendous ones tonight, he still has a respectable 40-yard average. Incidentally, talking about punting averages, with the new rule in college football this year requiring the interior lineman to stay on the line of scrimmage until that ball is kicked, a good long punt really isn't that helpful if they're going to return it 40 and 50 yards as well. So there's really not a necessity for a long punt too much, just a good high one.
Yellingsworth comes to the right. I think I said Owen scared last time it was shot, but this is Bobby Womack with shots out in front of him to block. And down goes Warmack as he gets out to the 15-yard line. With his arms around him, again, is Jack Reynolds along with Jimmy Weatherford. And again, Tennessee would like to stop the clock with 59 seconds to go. They've got another timeout left. Weatherford, who just made the tackle, comes from Dalton, Georgia, as we said. And the Tennessee coaching staff thinks so much of him that when they played Alabama, and of course they defeated Alabama, Weatherford was the man assigned to the All-American Dennis Holman of Alabama and did quite a job. In that same game, Albert Dorsey, the right cornerback, intercepted 3 balls, all in the fourth quarter, returning 131 yards for a touchdown, and that was his birthday present to himself. But Tennessee's got a lot of talent, far from being out of this game. Warmack holding onto the ball and gets out near the 20-yard line and near a first down, and has the first down for Oklahoma. 53 seconds to go. And again, as you can see, Pistol Pete Williams calling timeout for Tennessee.
And for most purposes, the timeouts that they have called are now, they're not gambling now to hold them, I wouldn't think, with just 53 seconds left. They're now calling the timeout to hopefully get a fumble, to effect a fumble on the part of Oklahoma. Because it looks like with
three downs to go, plus a kicking down, that they should be able to run the clock out at this point.
19-0 the score. There's Oklahoma, Big Eight champions, 9-1 record, facing Tennessee, the Southeastern Conference champions, 9-1 record. Last time they played in the Orange Bowl, they said it was the making of this great classic, and Tennessee won that one 17-0 back in 1939. There is Schatz again out to the 21-yard line. Steve Kiner made the stop with 45 seconds to go. And speaking of that 1939 Orange Bowl, Bob Woodruff, the athletic director at Tennessee, and George Capigo, one of the coaches, were players on Tennessee in that bowl game. 34 seconds to go. Clock, remember, continuing to run as Tennessee has run out of timeouts. Billingsworth to the right. Zabel to the left. Bob Womack talking to his fullback, Harper. Womack holding on to the ball, and that should be the last play of the first half. Steve Carroll of Chattanooga, Tennessee, number 70, again made the tackle as they'll count this down to halftime here at the 34th annual Orange Bowl. And the Sooners go to the dressing room, leading the Volunteers of Tennessee by the score of 19-0. And very quickly, onto the field in the end zone comes the Oklahoma marching band, the pride of Oklahoma, under the direction of Dr. Gene A. Brought. And bands, remember, get just as fired up as football teams, and I'm sure that the Sooner band is feeling pretty good right now at halftime with a score 19-0. After Oklahoma comes on, we'll have Tennessee, and then, of course, as we said, our Orange Bowl pageant. If you have never seen a halftime of an Orange Bowl before, stick with it. This is something to see. And if you have color, which I hope you do, you are the envy of your neighbors because it is brilliant. Here comes the pride of Oklahoma, University of Oklahoma marching band. Now, the featured twirlers are Miss Mary Ann Burke from Waterloo, Iowa. She's the 1964 National Baton Twirlers Association Championship of the champion of the United States and Canada. Miss Sheila Chambliss, the Texas State champion. And a freshman from Mount Vernon, Ohio, Dick Antill, the 1967 World's Champion and voted the outstanding twirler at the 1967 World's Fair. The drum majors, Lewis Gray of Dell City, Oklahoma, and Doug Monroe of Ann Arbor, Michigan, as the Oklahoma band now presents a show entitled Designs in Marching. And now, ladies and gentlemen, under the direction of Dr. Gene A. Brought, here is the University of Oklahoma marching band. Of course, was Lover, and they call this halftime show Designs in Marching. And this is the Washington Post box. Them bases mark. The Washington Post is to follow later. Down to Washington postmarked by John Philip Sousa. The announcement being made is that a John Philip Sousa stage is to be built in the John F. Kennedy Center for Performing Arts. And it is being, well, it is being helped along by contributions by the American Bandmasters Association. And, of course, that includes those in charge of colleges and high school bands across the country. City of Oklahoma Marching Band. And now, about to come onto the field, another fine marching band from the great Southeastern Conference School, the University of Tennessee. And by the way, the University of Tennessee Band, to show you how far back this goes, was organized immediately after the Civil War, when the university reopened. Since that time, their enrollment in this band has grown to more than 300 students in all of the bands from all of the colleges of the university. And of course, there are eight conferences, great colleges, rather, spread around the state of Tennessee. And here comes the drum major of the Tennessee band, Mr. Steve Singleton. The director is Dr. W.J. Julian. And now they'll come downfield, playing down the field, Tennessee's fight song. More than 77,000, thrilling to this halftime pageantry of the 34th annual Orange Bowl in Miami. And now the music of the magnificent men and their flying machine. Majorettes are Connie Phillips, Annabelle A.G., Pam Bailey, Mary Lou Allen, Becky Nanny, Rosemary Payne, Kathy Price, Mary Carolyn Roper, Elizabeth Sims, and Elaine White. And the music now to this precision drill is the trumpet tune by Purcell. Thank you. magnificent marching band of Tennessee, and now they will form a circle as we go to Broadway. And the Pride of the Southland Band will present a circle drill to the Broadway music of Cabaret. Listen to the crowd in the Orange Bowl have come to see not only a fine football game, but halftime pageantry. And I think it was Jimmy Durante who once said, "You ain't seen nothing yet." We still have another part of the halftime Orange Bowl pageantry. And at the end of the field is the Statue of Liberty, and the Tennessee Band will now thrill the crowd with a concert presentation, the Battle Hymn of the Republic. University of Tennessee Marching Band, directed by Dr. W.J. Julian. And the fabulous halftime activities will continue from the Orange Bowl after this pause for station identification.
See The Evil of Frankenstein in chilling color Tuesday night.
This 1968 Orange Bowl game is brought to you by United Airlines. Fly the friendly skies of United. By the Savings and Loan Association, serving America, where over 43 million people keep their savings. By the people in your town who bottle Coca-Cola. Coke has the taste you never get tired of. By Pontiac and your Pontiac dealers, the people who are having an us versus them comparison sale. And by new super king-size Winston cigarettes. The score at halftime is 19-0 Oklahoma, but the halftime pageant continues with the Orange Bowl presentation. And let's go down to the field for that.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Orange Bowl Fair. Here we have rides for you, entertainment for you. As we come to the middle, we have the beautiful merry-go-round. For just 10 cents, one thin part of a dollar, you can come and ride the merry-go-round. Around and around it goes. And on either side, you have all the beautiful floats. There are the prize winners. Look at the prize winners come by you. Come on down, the bearded lady. She has the largest beard in the world. And let me call your attention to the east side of the Orange Bowl by the Statue of Liberty. Look at that, risking life and limb as they walk across the wire. Ladies and gentlemen, take a look. Look at them risk their life for you as they go to the wire. And remember, that's only 100,000th of an inch. It's all dental floss. There, if you don't think it's dangerous, there used to be 12 of them. And now there is Mr. Peanut on the other side of the arena. Come on inside the tent. It's just 10 cents. One thin part of a dollar. One tenth of a dollar. 10 cents. Say you only have a $10 bill. We'll give you change later. And look. Look, the man is going to dive into an empty bucket. We use one every show, but it's a great act. And there, the Ferris wheel, the beautiful, exciting Ferris wheel. Just 10 cents for a ride. Anybody want a balloon? Balloons for everybody. Catch that man with the balloon and buy a balloon. Here it is, the greatest show. It's the Orange Bowl Fair. And lining up, the princesses and the queen of the Orange Bowl. Come on, ladies and gentlemen. Try your luck. Take a chance. Come on inside. See the strongest man in the world. He chews glass. He bites nails. He can't lift too much, but he's strong. Come on down. Just 10 cents. 10 cents. Well, would you believe 5 cents? It's the greatest, biggest show you've ever seen. It's the Orange Bowl Fair. So come on. And there they are lining up. It looks like it's going to be an exciting race between the queen and the princesses, ladies and gentlemen. Here it is. It's the Orange Bowl Fair. It's a great show. Look at the acts coming your way. The strong man, the bearded lady, everything for your entertainment. A high wire act. Look again, ladies and gentlemen, where the Statue of Liberty is. Look to that side of the stadium and see them swinging. And there's the high wire act. There they are, risking life and limb for you. Come on down, see the show. Just 10 cents. Just one tenth of a dollar to see the greatest show on earth. And here we are under the big top, the main arena. Come on down, 10 cents. One thin part of a dollar for your entertainment. Look at the prize winners coming by you. The Orange Bowl Fair prize winners. It's a great show, ladies and gentlemen. Don't miss it. Come on inside. See the acts. See the acts. Don't miss any one of them. It's a great, 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 exciting show. This Orange Bowl Fair is just for you. It's for you and the children. Come on down. It's a great, great, great show. We have the Ferris wheel, the bearded lady, the strong man. Come by a balloon. How about testing out some of the prize winners? Hamburgers and turkey and onions. It's a great, great, great show. And here's the race, ladies and gentlemen. It's the Orange Bowl Queen and the princesses. And there they go. It looks like it's the princess. No, it's the queen coming out to the front now, and the princesses as they make the far turn. Here they come down the stretch now. It's the princess on the outside, the queen's on the inside. It looks like it's going to be a tight race, ladies and gentlemen. And the winner, here they are as they come down to the finish line. It looks like the winner is, well, it's pretty close. We may have to wait for a photograph, ladies and gentlemen. We'll just have to wait for a photograph. It's so close. Ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce to you right now the Orange Bowl princesses and the queen. First of all, Princess Suzanne Van Horst, a 21-year-old blonde beauty from the University of Miami, a native-born Miamian, attended schools in Germany and France, as her father was a colonel in the United States Air Force. Princess Debbie Riker, a 19-year-old part-time model and real estate office worker from Burlington, New Jersey, originally, but a graduate of Miami Beach High School. Princess Nancy Brandon, 21-year-old secretary for a Miami insurance firm, part-time model, attends Miami-Dade Junior College evening classes, to major in photography and journalism. Princess Robin Whitley, 19-year-old University of Miami co-ed, part-time model majoring in music, born in San Diego, California. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Queen of the Orange Bowl, Queen Patricia Taylor, a statuesque 5'8 brunette from Fairfax, Virginia, a co-ed at the University of Miami, captain of the University of Miami Baton Twirling Corps, majoring in elementary education. Ladies and gentlemen, Queen Patricia Taylor. Now you're viewing this beautiful Orange Bowl Fair from wherever you are, way up at night with the lights out. This is it. This is the Orange Bowl Fair. And this is the way it looks at night. It's a great, great, great show, ladies and gentlemen. And now we have to pack up. There are other places to go and other shows to do. Next stop, Apalachicola. Happy New Year, everybody.
I believe you can use incredible and beautiful the halftime of this Orange Bowl. The score is Oklahoma 19 and Tennessee nothing. As we get ready for the second half kickoff of the 1968 Orange Bowl game. And now we return to our studios for this commercial message.
It's not how long you make it, it's how you make it long. It's not how long you make it, it's how you make it long. It's not how long you make it, it's how you make it long.
Everywhere you turn these days, you'll find new super king-size Winston cigarettes. All across the USA, smokers are discovering that just length alone can't make a cigarette taste one bit better. Anyone can make a cigarette long, but
it's not how long you make it. How you make it long.
And Winston makes it long by adding an extra measure of the famous good taste that has made Winston America's largest selling cigarette. Pick up a pack today.
Tastes good.
It's young.
It's Winston.
Jim Simpson back at the Orange Bowl in Miami. And before the second half resumes, Carl wrote, there are the statistics.
And as you can see, Oklahoma 150 yards compared to Tennessee 62 on the ground, 107 to 41 in the air, 257 to 103 overall. And you know, Jim, Tennessee has to make some changes. They may come out in an unbalanced line, but there will be some changes, I would assume, in their passing game particularly. One thing about Tennessee, they do have the manpower, great reserves who can step in without the team's effectiveness being hurt at all. Oklahoma, I would say, just keep that offensive line charging as it did in the first half. And number two, keep Bob Warmack healthy.
Carl Kremser will kick off for Tennessee. The Volunteers trailing by the score of 19 to nothing. And deep in the middle is Eddie Hinton, who has scored on a 21-yard pass from Bob Warmack. That is Rick Baldridge nearest to you. And across the way is Steve Owens, number 36. The first half was all Bob Warmack and all Oklahoma. Tennessee is out to see what it can do in the second half. There's Doug Dickey, arms folded, undefeated since the opening loss to UCLA in the last night game they played. And by the way, Oklahoma has played 172 consecutive games in the daytime. The last time they played at night was 1951, and they lost that one to Texas A&M 14-7. The last night game Tennessee played was at the beginning of 1967 season when they lost by the score of 20-16. And if you're wondering what is going on the field, well, we continue to talk up here. Something has gone wrong with the official clock. And they are now fixing it, and they have just fixed it and flashed it to the 15-minute mark. And so now, kicking off will be Kremser. And Hinton and Baldridge and Owens remain deep. Soccer-style kicker, born in Germany, as we said, discovered by others at Tennessee who called on their coaches to look at him. George Capigo looked at him and decided he's quite a kicker, which he is. That is Owens back at the one, the five, the 10. Gets out across the 20 and not much more. Dragged down there
And Oklahoma will put the ball in play there. David Murphy, number 25, a senior from Columbia, Tennessee, made the tackle. Bob Wormack trotting on. Wormack, back in the first quarter, ran 7 yards for the first Oklahoma score. In the second quarter, threw 21 yards to Hinton for a score, and then led Oklahoma down to the one-foot line where Steve Owens went over for the third Oklahoma score. Wormack hands to Ron Schatz, the tailback, who gets out to the 25-yard line. A gain of 4, it'll be second down and 6. Dick Williams, number 74, the left tackle from Greenville, Tennessee, made the tackle. Number 81 in your picture there is Jim McDonald, the defensive end, breaking out to the right. Next to him, Frank Yannissey, number 79. Carroll is in the middle there, playing middle guard, Steve Carroll. 32 in your picture is the monster man, Jimmy Glover. Wormack still has the ball, being rushed, and down he goes inside the 15-yard line. Breaking in quickly was Jim McDonald, the junior, right end from Knoxville, Tennessee.
There's one change, Jim, I think, that we have seen already in the Tennessee defensive alignment. Jim McDonald there, not even going for the fake to the tailback. Just staying outside, making sure that Wormack doesn't come out of there with that ball on his hip and in position to throw the ball.
We gave you half of the Tennessee defensive line. Dick Williams is at left tackle. Vic Dingus at left end. Weatherford, Jones, and Dorsey deep. Reynolds, Glover, and Kiner, the linebackers. Third down and 17. Wormack. Pass up the sidelines, and out of bounds it goes. Incomplete, and down goes a trainer across the way. Intended for Hinton, and over there with him was Jimmy Weatherford.
Apparently, Jim, this is a definite change they've made because it was the same play almost to the right side rather than to the left. And this time it was Vic Dingus, number 80, the Tennessee defensive end, who played it to the outside. Again, trying to keep Wormack from getting out there and in position and having enough time to let go of that ball under control.
Well, Pete Williams, the referee, is discussing the penalty. And we'll see exactly what it is as flags flew. Ineligible receiver downfield, charged, of course, against Oklahoma, has been refused by Tennessee. And so that makes it fourth down, and Gordon Wheeler, with 17 yards to go for the first down, has come in and is standing back on his own one and will kick the ball away to Bill Baker of Jasper, Tennessee, number 48. That is Wheeler. 40-yard kicking average, as he said, 19th in the nation. Baker in single safety. Gets the rush, but gets the ball away. A driving kick that Baker will take at the 46, across the 50. And down to the 40-yard line of Oklahoma and Tennessee, trailing 19-0, has good field position. In 1968, NBC will bring you two of television's most popular golf programs. Starting on January 20th, Emmy Award winner Shell's Wonderful World of Golf. Then later in the year, NBC will telecast four special Big Three golf tournaments between Arnold Palmer, Gary Player, and Jack Nicklaus. That's this year. More outstanding golf in color and exclusively on NBC. Chris is wide to the right. Dewey Warren is in at quarterback. Warren keeping the ball, and he is wrestled down by John Titsworth, the big right tackle, helped out by Jim Fires. Numbers 78 and 84. A gain from the 40-yard line down to the 37 of 3, second down 7. You're watching this 1968 Orange Bowl game from the Orange Bowl in Miami, Florida. It is live, it is in color, and it is exclusively on NBC, and we had 70 degrees at game time, and the temperature has gone up. It's now 74. Chris wide to the right, Flowers to the left. In motion comes Charlie Fulton. Warren dropping straight back. Warren with time, aims and has Chris. Chris gets down to the 25-yard line before he's tackled down there by Don Trimmer and Rick Goodwin. That's enough for the first down for Tennessee. The Volunteers trailing 19-0, hope to make the second half different.
Here we see Gary Chris going downfield, and he'll do a little turn in, just a little curl in. Number 91, Gary Chris, taking that ball for a first down.
12 minutes, 21 seconds to go in the third quarter. That is the Tennessee rooting section across the way. Flowers to the right, Chris to the left. From the 25 on first down, there is Charlie Fulton getting down to the 21-yard line. Dan Trimmer again in on the tackle. He is the game captain, a senior from Euless, Texas, number 43. Second down and 6. The ball on the 21.
11 minutes, 40 seconds to go. Chris goes out to the left. Flowers the slot back left. One. Little swing pass to Charlie Fulton. Gets past one man. And down he goes inside the 15 to the 12-yard line. Knocked down by Gary Harper. And had not Harper, their monster man, knocked him down, Fulton would have scored. First down, Tennessee. Fulton goes out and Chadwick comes in. Chadwick's number 20, the leading scorer for the Volunteers. As the Volunteer rooting section says, go. Flowers goes wide left. He's on the line. Chris is actually flanked in the backfield to the right. Warren. Chadwick throws a block across the way, and it is Flowers across the way inside the 10 down to the 9-yard line. Richmond Flowers over there with him. Knocked him out of bounds was Bobby Stevenson.
Usually you will see in the first series of drives, whether it be offensively for Oklahoma or for Tennessee, some of the adjustments being made or were made at the halftime. Apparently, Tennessee picking out some flaws in the Oklahoma defensive alignment, completing these last two passes, short passes, but completed.
Second down and 7 from the 9. Flowers left, Chris right. Warren looking for Flowers, and it's off his hands in the end zone. That's Steve Barrett back there with him, a junior from Artesia, New Mexico.
Here you see Flowers on the line of scrimmage. Just cutting across, doing a crisscross with his tight end. And Steve Barrett, number 35.
Kenny DeLong, whose brother was Steve DeLong, the winner of the Outland Trophy, is the outstanding defensive ball player of the year, 1965, an All-American, has just come in, number 82. Warren back. Warren in a crowd, and down he goes with Dick Peso, the left tackle making the stop back at the 16-yard line. They'll mark it at the 14. And that will bring up fourth down and long yardage. Fourth and 12 for the first down and 14 to go for the touchdown. And in comes the play from the bench. Out goes Mike Gooch. And in comes Kenny DeLong. Long running out to the right. Richmond Flowers flanked wide right. Close as the Volunteers have been all night. Warren with a big rush and throws to Chadwick, who can't hold on to it at the 14-yard line, and Oklahoma takes over. Gary Harper, the monster man, was there to break it up. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score is Oklahoma 19 and Tennessee nothing.
Good morning, sir.
7 a.m., right on time. Not much traffic.
Well, it's pretty early yet.
Which airline, gentlemen?
Drop me at United.
Me too.
United for me.
Oh, United.
Third quarter in the Orange Bowl, 9 minutes, 56 seconds to go. Oklahoma has taken over on downs on their own 14. First and 10, they lead 19 to nothing. Killingsworth and Hinton come to the left. Cormack 9 for 15 tonight. Cormack with the ball, holding on to it, and gets out near the 18-yard line before he is driven back. Jimmy Weatherford is at the bottom of that pile, number 30, along with Jack Reynolds, number 64. Dewey Warren, 3 for 5, as he led the Volunteers down the field to inside the 10-yard line, but could not take the ball in. A tremendous defensive rush put on by Oklahoma. Killingsworth and Hinton again wide left. Tailback goes straight ahead again. And that's Steve Owens, the sophomore from Miami, Oklahoma. Led the Big 8 in rushing and in scoring.
12 touchdowns, 72 points, and he's got one tonight, number 36. Now again, a big play for Oklahoma, and of course for Tennessee, which needs the football. Third down and two from the 22-yard line of Oklahoma. Inman and Killingsworth again left. And again, Owens has the ball, and he's got the first down out across the 25-yard line to the 26.
And again, we have seen that Oklahoma offensive line beating the defensive line of Tennessee to the ball. Coming off that ball extremely well. They're driving them back, I would say, 2 and 3 yards every time.
Well, Kyle, as we talked to the coaches earlier in the week, they told us that there's no need to have a computer or a big scouting film for Oklahoma. They simply give the ball to the tailback and have him run off tackle. That's Mr. Warmack has been doing a lot of running himself tonight. There's Warmack again, handing again to his tailback, and this time Owens may have gotten a yard and no more. Jack Reynolds, who calls defensive signals, and remember he's a sophomore from Cincinnati, Ohio, has been in on the majority of the tackles tonight, along with Steve Carroll. Second down and 10. Womack keeps the ball, now pitches it back to him, and comes around, and he is back out of bounds by Vic Dingo. An offensive left end. 7 minutes, 28 seconds to go. 19-0 Oklahoma. We're in the third quarter. And it is third down. The ball on the Oklahoma 31, and they've got five to go. We come up again to the third down situation. Last time it was third and two, and Owens carried for the first down. Now it is third down and five. Owens in motion, that usually means a passing play. And he's going to throw and intercept it down the sideline. Goes Jimmy Glover, touchdown. And Tennessee's right back in the ballgame. Glover, the monster man. And you know, as we watch it on instant replay, Kyle Roach, you can see him go all the way there from outside the 30, about 37 yards. We'll check. Warmack is the man who missed the tackle. But you know, if I know when a man goes in motion, it's going to be a pass play, you know doggone well the Tennessee defense does.
Well, you know, Jim, this is the same play that they had completed successfully in the first quarter, in their first drive in the first quarter, about three times in that first quarter. And apparently, Tennessee made the adjustment.
Bremser kicks the extra point, and the Volunteers have come back. 7 minutes, 17 seconds to go to third quarter, and action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score now, Oklahoma 19 and Tennessee 7.
Money is a hat your husband laughs at. Money is wire wheels, bucket seats, and four on the floor. Money is your child's allowance. Money is a trip to Mexico. Money is blueprints and bricks, plywood and plumbing. Money is your first home. Money is jobs and wages and profit. Money is progress. And your nearby savings and loan association is working for you and your community by keeping money on the move. It starts here in a savings account where your money earns income. Your savings are combined with the savings of others and loaned to families who want to buy or build homes. Money goes to a builder who buys materials and pays his employees who pay the grocer, the cleaner, the butcher, never ending. Money on the move. It begins at your savings and loan association.
Jim Simpson back at the Orange Bowl in Miami, and Tennessee has gone wild. Kyle Kremser to kick off to Eddie Hinton. Lots of time to play, and Kremser puts his foot in this one, driving Hinton deep in the end zone, and he'll stay right there. First and 10, Oklahoma at the 20. And in situations like this, Kyle Road, as you well know, through your experience in bowl games and in collegiate football,
A break such as that can fire up a team like the Volunteers, who have appeared to be rather flat thus far.
Well, I know the word momentum is overused quite a bit, but there is such a thing, and it appears as though right now Oklahoma is fighting momentum. Tennessee apparently has it. We'll see.
Bob Womack again, and is hit, and down he goes after a gain of 3 yards. And there's that number 64 one more time, Jack Reynolds. Sophomore calls defensive signals, makes a bundle of tackles, a gain of 3 at second down 7.
Jim, it's an interesting thing now. Apparently, Tennessee has figured out some of the things that Oklahoma was doing in that first half. We'll see if Oklahoma, in turn, can make new adjustments, as they must if the other team has them figured out. We'll see what Bob Womack comes with.
Sable now splits to the right, Killingsworth to the left. Womack still has the ball. Fires it, intercepted again by Tennessee. And down goes number 30, Jimmy Weatherford. Ken Mendenhall made the stop. The ball is inside the 20 at the 18.
And here we see the pass intended for Eddie Hinton. Jim Weatherford stepping in, getting, I think, his third interception of the season.
Tennessee with great field position, trailing 19-7, 6.5 minutes to go. Oklahoma scored 19 points in the first half. Tennessee is trying to come back. Richmond Flowers comes out to the right. Dewey Warren answers tailback, and down he goes. Granville Liggins made the big play on Charlie Fulton. Liggins, number 66, one of the All-Americans on the Oklahoma team. Tosses him back to the 21-yard line. It'll be second down and 14.
And there have been some great comebacks in Orange Bowl history. 1943, Alabama trailed Boston College by 14 points at the half. Came back to win it 37-21.
Flowers goes wide left. Second down. Tennessee trying to get its offense going. Warren has his man across the middle. Down to the 20 he goes. That is number 82, Kenny DeLong, the brother of the All-American guard. Bruce Denfruit knocked him down. It's at the 5-yard line, and it's first and goal to go. In 1942, Georgia intercepted 6 passes against Texas Christian. Tennessee hasn't done that against Oklahoma yet, but the Volunteers are back in business. Flowers goes wide left. Chris comes to the right. Fulton and Pickens the setbacks. Warren carries the ball, pitches to Fulton. Fulton with a blocker, touchdown!
And there you see number 34, Pickens, who threw a tremendous block for Charlie Fulton. Here we see that play again. You'll watch Pickens, number 34, the fullback, after Fulton gets the pitch out. And Fulton, 10 for a touchdown for Tennessee.
Carl Kremser is coming in shades of this afternoon's Sugar Bowl, when Wyoming led 13-0 at the half, only to lose to LSU 20-13 in the second half. Tennessee hasn't come all the way back yet, but they are trying. Kremser's kick is good. Within 2 minutes, Tennessee has scored twice. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Oklahoma 19, Tennessee 14.
Can we interest you in a nice, simple way to enjoy a bottle of Coca-Cola? First, you find a place like this, on a day when the air is especially crisp. And then find a stream, one that's icy cold. And that's where you place your bottle of Coca-Cola. And when you take your first sip, you'll think it's the most delicious, refreshing bottle of Coke in the whole world. Can't talk you into it, huh? Okay, then. Stay right at home. Drop a few ice cubes into a glass and pour yourself the most delicious refreshment in the whole world. Well, that's the thing about Coca-Cola. Wherever you have it, it always tastes the way this looks. Because Coca-Cola has the taste you never get tired of. That's why things go better with Coke after Coke after Coke.
From the the frantic Orange Bowl in Miami. Jim Simpson with Kyle Roach. Carl Kremser will kick off and kicks it deep. Not as deep this time as Hinton comes out to the four to take it for Oklahoma. Across the 15. And down he goes as he hits to the 22-yard line. Fine tackle there by Jimmy Weatherford. As we pause briefly for station identification, this is the NBC Television Network. Happy New Year to you from NBC Sports. We are thrilled that as the last of our triple header on New Year's Day, the Sugar Bowl and the Rose Bowl, that we can bring you this kind of color and this kind of football game. From the 22, Warmack hands to Owens' tailback, and he gets to the 25. And look who's getting up again, number 64, Jack Reynolds. Dion, if I said that one time tonight, I've said it 10.
Well, it's indicative of the alteration the Tennessee team has made in their defensive alignment, particularly on these just tailback slants off tackle. They fill the gap.
Second down and 7. Killingsworth goes wide right. Warmack with the ball. Running out. Carroll is there. Gets by Carroll, and now Carroll catches up to him. Fumble on the play, and Tennessee recovers. Hold it. They're waving him off the field. The crowd went wild. The official signaled first down Tennessee, but now they're bringing the ball back and saying, no, sir, it belongs to Oklahoma. Dick Dingus is the man who jumped on the ball and the ball carrier. It is at the 29, and it will be third down and short yardage, about 3. The whistle had blown the play dead. 19-14, the score, Oklahoma, 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Killingsworth comes out to the left, and this is the game you would expect between a second and a third-ranked team. On third down, into the middle, goes Owens. Close to the first down. And may have it. First down for Oklahoma. The Sooners maintain possession of the ball. Tennessee in bowl games to date has won 5, lost 7. Oklahoma has won 7, including 4 Orange Bowls, and lost 4, including 2 Orange Bowls. Killingsworth to the left. Warmack is 9 for 17 with 2 interceptions, one of which has scored a touchdown, the other has set up a touchdown. This is Owens again for a short yardage. Getting up is Jack Reynolds. As Jack Parr would say, I kid you not, he made another tackle.
And again, the Oklahoma line now facing a real challenge. They had it pretty much their own way in that first half. They're getting their mettle tested. Steve Owens, number 36, the tailback for Oklahoma. Ideal size, 195, 6'2", good speed.
A record crowd looking on. 2 minutes, 40 seconds to go. Third quarter, 19-14 Oklahoma. Second down and 7. Warmack throwing. Hinton out of bounds. And he dropped the ball. Over there with him was the All-American cornerback, Albert Dorsey, a senior. And that is Bob Warmack, who had such a great first half with a 7-yard touchdown run, a 21-yard pass to Hinton, a 38-yard run that set up another touchdown. But here in the second half, Jimmy Glover's intercepted and returned 36 yards for a touchdown. Weatherford is intercepted, and Charlie Fulton has scored on 5 yards out. Within 2 minutes and 10 seconds, Tennessee, with its defensive team doing the biggest part of the work, scored twice. Third down and long yardage, 7 for Oklahoma from its own 36. And Warmack scoring the throw. Warmack throws, and it is incomplete. It's fourth down, and Oklahoma has to kick the ball away. Weatherford over there defending. The ball was intended, I believe, for Killingsworth, the sophomore from Oklahoma City, number 83. Bill Baker, the junior from Jasper, Tennessee, goes back in single safety formation, and Gordon Wheeler is in to do the kicking. Now Tennessee drops a couple of men back in short safety. So 3 men are back. They're not rushing the kicker. Wheeler booms one. Baker has to chase it, takes it over the head, is back to the 6. The 10. running wide and drive down to the 18. And listen to this record crowd of the Orange Bowl. Kyle, they have gone wild.
If he could have gotten to the outside, that Tennessee had a complete wall lined up here.
Today in the Sugar Bowl, LSU came from behind in the second half to beat Wyoming 20-13. Texas A&M upset Alabama 20-16 in the Cotton Bowl. USC defeated Indiana 14-3 in the Rose Bowl, the number one team. And don't forget, following this Orange Bowl game, to stay tuned for Bowl Day 68 with Pat Hernan. Highlights of all of today's bowl activity. It's been quite something. From their own 17, that is Charlie Fulton in motion. Ball is handed to Richard Pickens, the fullback, and he gets out across the 20 to the 22 before Dick Peso and Don Primer make the tackle. Peso, they call Pops. He's 25 years old, was in the Army for a couple of years, worked for a little while, and then thought he might be too old to go to college. Finally, he convinced himself that he wasn't, gets B averages in accounting, and he is only a couple of years younger than some of the coaches.
I don't know whether you can notice it as much as I do, Jim, or at least or if you agree with me, but this Tennessee club is really fired up. They're coming off that ball like they never have in that first half.
Second down, six. Warren with the ball. Flag goes down as Dewey Warren gets to the 25. And defensive holding is going to be charged against Tennessee. And that will drive the Volunteers back. Well, when Warmack was having the great moments in the first half, we gave you his nickname, which is the Worm. Dewey Warren's is Swamp Rat, because he used to have to walk through the swamps around Savannah, Georgia in order to get to school when he was a kid. The option's being explained now to the Oklahoma team. As we pointed out, the initial signal was holding, and I would assume they would want that big chunk of yardage, which they do. So Pete Williams steps it off back to the 11, 11 and a half, and now we'll give you the signal. So it is second down and long yardage to go. 16, a minute and 32 seconds to go. Third quarter, Oklahoma 19, Tennessee 14. So at halftime was Oklahoma 19, Tennessee nothing. Gary Chris trots out to the left. Chadwick in motion. Warren hands to his wing back. Richmond Flowers has got all the speed in the world, and he's got the first down as he cracks out across the 35. Richmond Flowers, battled with the virus this week, an Olympic hopeful, an All-American, gives him first down after a second down, 17 run out to the 36. Jim Files made the tackle.
And a beautiful inside reverse. Flowers lined up in the halfback position on that play, taking that inside reverse, cutting over his right guard.
Gary Chris comes out to the right with him, the monster man, Gary Harper. Dewey Warren with the ball and falls down after a yard gain. Gary Chris, number 91 in your picture. Number 12 is Charlie Fulton. Number 34 is Richard Pickens, the fullback. Number 20 coming in now is Walter Chadwick as Fulton trots out. 33 seconds left in the third quarter. Richmond Flowers out here, and the monster man, Gary Harper, is out with him. Over the middle to DeLong. DeLong is out past midfield and into Oklahoma territory. Another first down, Tennessee. 9 seconds to go in the third quarter, and not another play will be gotten off. 1 second. That's it. That's the end of the third quarter in this exciting 1968 Orange Bowl game. The score, Oklahoma 19, Tennessee 14.
Recognize him? The great American car shopper. You know what he's doing? He's comparing our Pontiac Catalina to the so-called low-priced cars. Because right now, Pontiac dealers are having a comparison sale. He's comparing the track.
Wider. That's wider.
It's wide track. He's comparing the engine.
It's bigger. Oh, it's bigger.
Bigger. Now he's comparing the wheelbase.
It is longer.
It is longer. Early he finds out how little it costs.
Well, who?
He found out.
Us comparison shoppers made Pontiac everything it is today.
Now, wait till he finds out us is having a sale.
We pause now for station identification.
See the premiere of Shell's Wonderful World of Golf, Saturday, January 20th.
Along with 77,943 others, a record crowd for the Orange Bowl and for a sports event here in the Southeast, this is Jim Simpson with Kyle Rote, and we have 15 minutes of play left. First and 10, Tennessee on the 48 of Oklahoma, 19-14, Oklahoma leads. Warren handing the ball to Pickens, his fullback, and he gets a tough yard or two. Granville Liggins making the stop.
And Jim, you know, we talked so much about that heralded duel between Granville Liggins, the middle guard for Oklahoma, number 66, and Bob Johnson, the All-America for Tennessee, number 54. It has really turned into a two-on-one duel. Liggins is having two men assigned to him on these pass patterns. Johnson and Rosenfelder to the right, Art Johnson and Graham to the left.
Jerry Chris to the right, Charlie Fulton in motion. Flowers to the left. Looking, and they have Chris. Chris gets away from one man and another. And inside the 30, he goes to the 28-yard line of Oklahoma. Gary Chris, number 91, a sophomore from Oliver Springs, Tennessee. And there was talk today of Terry Dalton, a junior, starting ahead of Chris. But Gary has earned his keep with that one. And Granville Liggins dropped off the line to make the stop. First down. And now Tennessee is going to call timeout. Charlie Fulton is going to the sidelines, and so is Dewey Warren, and so is Gary Chris. Warren is 9 for 17 now with two interceptions. Two interceptions also for Bob Wormack. Well, as we take a deep breath and Dewey Warren talks to Doug Dickey, his coach, we'll remind you that besides this New Year's Day tripleheader, we'll telecast two other outstanding postseason games. Next Saturday, and that's January 6th. Remember, this is 1968. Starting at 2 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, the Senior Bowl from Mobile, Alabama, with the top players from the North against the best of the South. Then on Sunday, January 21st, starting at 1:30 Eastern Standard Time, the American Football League All-Star Game. The top AFL Eastern Division players against the best of the West. Two more outstanding postseason games in color and exclusively on NBC. Across the way, Dewey Warren talking with Doug Dickey. 13 minutes, 52 seconds to go. Kyle Rote.
And with enough time to not make it critical right now, we might point out something that might be of interest to the ladies watching it, since they sometimes wonder about costumes and what have you. Some of the jerseys out here tonight have stripes on them. Some do not. Those that do not, particularly for the Oklahoma team, are the tearaway jerseys that the fellas go in and change at the half. That will tear away so loose. That's one of the reasons why some of the boys will have stripes on their uniform on the same team and some will not.
Fashion commentary by Kyle Rote. DeLong to the left, Flowers to the right. Warren has his instructions and has a first down. Hands to his fullback, Pickens. Pickens inside the 25, inside the 20, down to the 11-yard line goes Randall Pickens. With Bobby Stevenson, number 31, making the stop. First and 10 at the 11-yard line. Bob Johnson really led the way there, the All-American center from Cleveland, Tennessee.
And here we see Warren under, and there you see some tremendous maneuvering on the part of Richard Pickens, number 34. And some great blocking in there by Bob Johnson, Charlie Rosenfelder, and John Boynton on the right side.
Gary Chris goes to the right. Flowers is the slot back on the right side. First down from the 11-and-a-half. Pitch out to Charlie Fulton. Fulton fakes the pass and is dragged out of bounds by number 81, John Kohler, the defensive left end from Burke Burnett, Texas, a senior. Stops the clock with 13 minutes and 7 seconds to go. The ball is on the 10, second down 9. Oklahoma 19, Tennessee 14. 77,943. The temperature in the mid-70s. And the halftime and pregame pageants have been something to see. And what do you think of the football game? Flowers to the right. Warren hands again to his fullback, and Pickens gets maybe a yard inside the 10 down to the 9. That's John Titsworth, number 78, getting up. A junior, 6'3", 215. Third down, and about 8 to go for a touchdown. And 6 to go for the first down. Warren, looking, firing, knocked down, incomplete. Looked like Dick Peso and Granville Liggins were in to break it up.
And with so much time remaining in the game to be played, 12 minutes and 27 seconds, the field goal certainly is the call.
Well, Carl Kremser, who has kicked 10 of 15 tries before tonight, we'll try this one from the 16 with Dewey Warren holding. It'll be a 26-yard field goal if it is good. And it'll make the score 19-17. The kick is good. From 26 yards out, and Tennessee draws within 2. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Oklahoma 19, Tennessee 17. And we return now to our studios for this commercial message.
I'd walk a mile for a camel.
This little demonstration was strictly for smokers who never tasted a camel cigarette. Camel smokers, you know what we mean. You other guys, start walking.
You're looking from the end zone past the orange grove as Kremser kicks off. Hinton is the man deep and takes it on the 2. Across the 20 with a burst of speed, he gets out to the 27-yard line. Eddie Hinton. Jimmy Weatherford made the tackle. Oklahoma has the ball. And we've said it before as Bob Womack drops in, and we will say it again. That the Sooners, in case you are just joining us, scored all 19 points in the first half. And in the second half, it has been all Tennessee with 17 points. 19-17, 12 minutes and 17 seconds to go. Billingsworth to the right. There is Schatz, and Schatz picks up good yardage. He's across the 30 now to the 33-yard line. Jim McDonald, the junior right defensive end, number 81, made the tackle. Steve Kiner also in on the tackle, the sophomore from Tampa, Florida, number 57.
Incidentally, on these off-tackle slants that Oklahoma is running, there's no deception other than what Warmack might do with the ball, whether he keeps it or hands it off. But as far as the blocking's concerned, it's all zone blocking, position blocking, rule blocking up along the front. No crossing, no traps.
Second down and 4. Shots with the ball again, and this time he picks up a yard or 2 out near the 35. Steve Kiner from that right side linebacker position, and again Jim McDonald in on the tackle. Same two combined to stop shots at the 35-yard line. And now it is third down and a long 2 yards to go. Big play again for Oklahoma and Tennessee. Billingsworth comes to the right. Warmack keeping the ball, being pursued, and wrestled down shy of the first down. Over there was Vic Dingus, along with Jack Reynolds, but it was Dingus of Kingsport, Tennessee, number 80, who made the tackle.
fourth down, and Oklahoma will have to kick the ball away unless it chooses to gamble, which I doubt. Because already Gordon Wheeler has come in to do the kicking. There's the fourth down marker, and that's how far they've got to go for the first down. Bill Baker goes deep. Wheeler, you're looking at now, will do the punting. Baker last time had a good punt return and gave Tennessee good field position. Watches this one bounce, and now will lay off of it as it goes out of bounds, and they'll mark it at the 18-yard line. First and 10 for Tennessee. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Oklahoma 19 and Tennessee 17.
9 years ago, United Airlines sold Dave and Joan Rundell a round-trip ticket to Hawaii. They still haven't used the other half. Would you like to see what they've been doing?
Everybody knows I got a happy life. Got no troubles, got a wonderful wife. Do a lot of swimming, it's good for me. Catch a little dinner from the bright blue sea. Never have a worry living on.
We've got to confess, we make it awfully easy to come to Hawaii. You can charge your airfare with a United credit card and most of the other things, too. And you don't have to spend 9 years here like the Rundells. Gosh, you wouldn't want to do that. Or would you?
If I may be permitted to editorialize, with the Statue of Liberty replica at the end zone, and of course, the queens of this Orange Bowl pageant, 77,943, and the two fine football teams of Tennessee and Oklahoma, on a New Year's Day, well, we're proud to be here and just a part of it, the whole country. First down 10. Warren hands off, and going nowhere as Granville Ligon fakes the tackle as Richmond Flowers, the wingback, who tried to cut back. A loss on the play from the 17 back to the 15. It'll be second down and 13. 19-17 the score. We've got 10 minutes left, Kyle.
And again, throughout this ballgame, it's not amazing, but it's quite interesting to see the respect this Tennessee club has for Granville Liggins at the middle guard spot. Only on these rare trick plays have they not assigned two men on it.
Flowers wide right. Warren is going to throw from deep in his own territory, from his five, and look out, it's going to be intercepted by Stevenson. Stevenson down the sidelines, touchdown! Oklahoma uses the interception to move out in front.
And Jim, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, he has now intercepted three passes and returned three for touchdowns.
You're exactly right. Twice before tonight, he intercepted passes, and each time,
There he is. Bob Stevenson, number 31, kept his record intact. Three interceptions, returned four touchdowns. All four.
I don't know which one she is. She is certainly not the gentleman right there, but Bobby Stevenson has a sister who is a cheerleader here, and I imagine that she is cheering extra hard. That's the first time the Sooners have gotten on the scoreboard and missed the second half. Mike Fashawn is in. Warmack takes the high pass from center, and the kick is good. Oklahoma moves out in front, 26-17. They've been in front. They're just moving a little farther out in front. Now, besides this New Year's triple header, and what a day this has been, we will also telecast two other outstanding postseason games. On Saturday, that's next Saturday, January the 6th, starting at 2 o'clock Eastern Time, that Senior Bowl from Mobile, Alabama, with the top players in the North against the best of the South. And on Sunday, January the 21st, starting at 1:30 Eastern Standard Time, the American Football League All-Star Game, the top AFL Eastern Division players against the best of the West. Two more outstanding postseason games in color and exclusively on NBC. Charlie Fulton is deep as Vachon will kick off. Fulton gets back across the 20, out to the 23-yard line, where he's contained there by number 60, Bill Efstrom of Oklahoma.
Well, Jim, there's no doubt that Tennessee had the momentum going for them up until that interception. Be quite a test of them right now to see if they can regain it and get back in this ballgame, trailing now by 9 points.
Tennessee, Daigle has come in on defense for Oklahoma. Chadwick has the ball and gets out across the 30 to the 31-yard line. John Titswip makes the tackle along with Granville Liggins.
There we see Liggins, a good shot of him. Look how he met that blocker and still held on to the tackle.
Make that touchdown interception of Bobby Stevenson, 26 yards. That is official. It is second down and three to go. Tennessee now trailing by 9, then Flowers to the left, and now they're going to call timeout. Tennessee has decided to call timeout and figure out what must be done with 8 minutes and 53 seconds left. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Oklahoma 26, Tennessee 17.
Here we go. All right, I get to go first.
Yeah. We're about to see the playing of a dangerous new game. It's called the credit game. Let's watch. The first player has turned up a credit card that enables him to buy another car and advance to Easy Street.
Don't worry, I got a credit card.
And here's one for a vacation tour. Here's a different kind of card, a savings account at a savings and loan association. This card may be kept until needed. And there are credit cards for boats, furniture and appliances, fur coats, most everything you'd ever want. But sooner or later, you're bound to run into a card that says, pay all bills, plus carrying charges. If you've saved at a savings and loan association, you're still in good shape. If you haven't saved, the game can be disastrous. In real life, too, the abuse of credit is a dangerous game. To win, you need a savings account at your nearby savings and loan association. Saving makes the difference.
We're not picking on just any pretty girl. Wave, if you will, Vivian. That is Vivian Stevenson, whose brother Bobby Stevenson just returned that intercepted pass for 26 yards in the score. And she's quite proud. Tennessee has the ball now, second down and three to go from the 30. Oklahoma band plays. Warren with the ball on his hip, setting up and throwing long to Richmond Flowers, who has it at the 48. Down to the 46-yard line goes Richmond Flowers, with Bobby Stevenson making the tackle. Tennessee, Kyle, comes right back.
And Dewey Warren with some beautiful faking in that backfield, faking to both of his backs. And during the meantime, Richmond Flowers going downfield at about three-quarter speed. And when he hit that point about 15 or 17 yards downfield, cut over the middle into the big open spot. Some beautiful faking by Dewey Warren that set that play up.
Gary Crist trots out to the right. Richmond Flowers comes wide left at the bottom of your screen. First down from the 46. Charlie Fulton with the ball back to the line of scrimmage. A nice bit of movement by Charlie Fulton to get down to the 42. That's Rick Goodwin, 52, and Jim Files, 84, who made the tackle.
And again, the man that made him make that maneuver, Granville Liggins, number 66. What a ball game he's playing.
Second down and 7. Again, Chris left, Flowers right. 7 minutes, 45 seconds to go. 26-17, Oklahoma. There goes the tailback. Walter Chadwick is coming to the ball game across the 40, down to the 37. He is shy by a couple of yards that first down. Dick Peso made the stop.
And we talked about how similar these two clubs were at the beginning of the ball game, and there you see it again. The identical play that Oklahoma had been running so much during the ball game. The tailback slant off tackle.
Richmond Flowers has caught 4 passes for a total of 68 yards. Third down and 3. Flowers to the left. In motion comes Walter Chadwick, and Warren drops back. Looking, ball is off the hands of everybody, intended for Flowers on the far sideline. He was double-teamed by Gary Harper and Rick Goodwin, and also over there was Kenny DeLong, number 82. They had two receivers, Kyle, in the same spot.
And a good assist to John Kohler, number 81, the big defensive end for Oklahoma, who made Warren throw that ball a little high. He had his arms outstretched as they came in, rushing the passer on the play.
Fourth down and 3. Charlie Fulton has come in with a play. Tennessee needs points. They're running out of time. 7 minutes and 2 seconds left. So on fourth down, they'll go for it. Fulton in motion.
Warren will throw. Getting a rush over the center, has the first down to DeLong. Inside the 30, down to the 27-yard line. Kenny DeLong and Gene Cagle, a safety man, and Don Primmer, the senior right side linebacker, made the stop. Cagle is playing because on Stevenson's touchdown interception, Barrett, who was injured in practice earlier, was injured again in the ankle. He's their top safety man. Ball on the 27-yard line. First down, Tennessee. Flowers goes to the right, Chris to the left. 6.5 minutes left. Oklahoma leading by 9. Pickens, the fullback, inside the 25 and down to the 22. That is Goodwin getting up after the stop. Long yardage. It'll be second down and 4 after the 6-yard pickup. Make that second and 5.
You know, they talk about a team being able to pick up the key third down. I don't guess there's any doubt that a fourth down is a key down.
Chris is to the left, and now there's some confusion. And Oklahoma's jumping around because Dick Peso did not feel that he should be in there. Number 79 is coming off now, and they're rushing in. Number 55 of Oklahoma, Larry Crutchman. A senior. Well, those two gentlemen there may look to you as though they're simply onlookers, but the man seated is Ernie Seiler, waving at us. The first Orange Bowl game back in 1933, this gentleman helped put on. He is still the executive director of the Orange Bowl Committee. Dan McNamara there is his assistant. And what a pageant and what a ball game they have put on. There is Dick Peso, the junior from Newton, Massachusetts, who's come off to the side. Second down and 5, exactly 6 minutes to go. 26-17. And Kyle, what is left to say? I think the pictures tell the story.
And we have Tennessee in great position right now. And now we have down on the two sidelines, the Oklahoma and Tennessee Rooters started competing with one another.
The music you probably hear most of is Boomer Sooner. Dime will be back in, the ball on the 22-yard line. Second down and 5 to go for Tennessee. As you look across the way now at Tennessee. Nope, this is Oklahoma on this side. In any event, it is second down and 5. Warren looking to run with the ball. Does. Keeping his balance, the first down to the 12-yard line goes Dewey Warren. And hurt is Granville Liggins up on the 22. Liggins, the All-American, holding on to his knee. Now remember, not only is he an All-American, but Oklahoma has never lost a regular for any game this year. Liggins, of course, has played most of this game, but in the closing 5 minutes and 51 seconds, this is where you need your All-American on defense. It will be a first down for Tennessee. Liggins holding on to that knee, and now the trainer working over him, and Tennessee standing around. 5 minutes, 51 seconds to go.
I'm sure Liggins getting caught in the cutoff blocks by the left side of Tennessee's line as they pull out on that sprint, cutting back. There is no such thing as flipping within the tackles on the offensive line of scrimmage. And you can, however, you can cut a man off from pursuit. And I'm sure, not sure, but that's how many of the knees get hurt on in the interior part of the line. I see going in to replace him is number 94, Joe Posley.
Liggins still on the field with the 5 minutes and 51 seconds to go. And I think a Granville now will try to get up. As he does, the ball is on the 12-yard line. But that could be all for Granville Liggins for tonight. It certainly looks like it. And Oklahoma has lost its defensive lineman of the year. And what a game he has played this evening. Tennessee trying to come back. Rick Goodwin trotting back on the field as Liggins comes off. On the 11-yard line now, Chris comes out to the left. First down. Warren pitching back as his man Chadwick, who gets down to the 6-yard line. A pickup of 6. It'll be second down and 4. Now coming in is Dick Peso, who went out also injured. Peso and Liggins were both out of there, but now Peso has come back. And Hoslick is coming out. Larry Kutchmer is actually the replacement for Granville Liggins, a senior, number 55. Second down from the 7, 5 to go for the first down. Dewey Warren pitching back again. This is Fulton. Fulton gets inside the 5 and down near the first down. Flag is down on the 5-yard line. And they are talking to Oklahoma. 26-17 the score. 5 minutes, 40 seconds to go in a wild, wild one.
And we can't forget either that Tennessee has some boys in that backfield who can throw the ball. Chadwick, Fulton, any of them who might be in there.
Ball is back to the 11-yard line for offside charge against the Volunteers. And Kyle, we'll point out one more time, as you did earlier, when Chadwick threw, and he's only thrown twice this year, each time has been for a touchdown. You can't get much better than that.
No.
And Bobby Stevenson of Oklahoma, to give credit where credit is due, he has 3 interceptions, and each time, including tonight, he is gone for a touchdown. Now Charlie Fulton has moved in to replace Dewey Warren, that quarterback. He can run and throw. He's running out, looking to sprint. Passes to Chadwick. Chadwick inside the 5 and down near the 3. He'll be shy of the first down, but not by much, and it'll be third down.
And a tremendous block put on by Richard Pickens, number 34, the fullback, leading the play.
For those of you around the country who I am sure are interested in the injury to Granville Liggins, a dislocated knee, the initial prognosis. Now with third down.
This is the replay, and you'll see the block by Pickens, number 34, right to the left of your screen.
Fulton going now, cutting back, trying to get down, either for the first down or the touchdown. He is close to both. Let's see where they mark it. Ball is marked on the 2. And it's a yard and a half away from a first down and 2.5 yards away from a touchdown. Joey Grayson has come in. It is fourth down. And Tennessee is going to call timeout. Charlie Fulton is going over to talk to his coach, Doug Dickey, to see what in the world he must do. Action will continue here at the Orange Bowl. The score, Oklahoma 26 and Tennessee 17.
Charlie is gift shopping for something his wife's always wanted, AC spark plugs. Gift wrapped in beautiful packages from General Motors. GM uses only AC plugs, so he'll get full-time firepower in every Chevrolet, Pontiac, Oldsmobile, Buick, and Cadillac. He could give her ACs in this package, but you know how wives are.
Y'all know what this is? An AC oil filter for your car. And you know what's inside it? More than 12 feet of the finest filtered material ever invented. Akron. You know what an AC oil filter does, don't you? It filters the dust and the grime and the dirt out of your engine oil. It'll give you thousands and thousands of gallons of clean oil before you have to change it. Now, that's worth bragging about. See it?
There's the clock, 4 minutes, 36 seconds to go. Fourth down, a yard and a half to go for the first down. 2.5 for the touchdown. Dewey Warren is coming at quarterback. Warren hands to Chadwick. Chadwick, I am sure, at least has the first down. First down and goal to go. One of the Oklahoma players, Jim Files, raced off the field for the moment as you watch it on instant replay, thinking they'd held him.
And that's what did it, that dive. Up and over.
Now fourth down. Or rather, first down and goal to go after the fourth down. Warren goes, touchdown.
And we might point out there's no percentage in going for the 2-point extra point now. They trail by 3. 2 wouldn't help them any more than 1.
Carl Kremser has come in to kick the extra point. 4 minutes and 5 seconds left, and I'm sure you're wondering about that. Warren to hold. Kremser's kick is good. There's the score. The Sooners of Oklahoma 26, the Volunteers 24. And I'm sure that Tennessee folks know that as you look at the injured Randall Liggins, that a field goal can win it for Tennessee. And of course, Oklahoma will try to run out that clock. Our thanks to the Orange Bowl Committee and its president, Bill Lantab, the executive director, whom you just met on camera, Ernie Seiler, and its assistant, Dan McNamara. Also, Hal Fleming, the publicity director, Jack Hodling, and the entire Orange Bowl staff. And from the University of Oklahoma, athletic director Gomer Jones, the head coach Chuck Fairbanks and his staff, and his football team. What a game they played. The sports information director, Harold Keith. From the University of Tennessee, athletic director Bob Woodruff. Head coach Doug Dickey and his staff and his football team. What a game they have played. And the sports information director, Haywood Harris. Kremser will kick off. 26-24, 4 minutes, 5 seconds to go. You've heard it said many times before, but this is an Orange Bowl classic. Kremser kicking to Eddie Hinton. Takes it at the 1. The 10. The 15. Gets out to the 20, the 22-yard line. And down he goes there. Knocked down by Mike Gook, a junior from Florence, Alabama. They'll mark it at the 21 with the time 3:56, Kyle, and Oklahoma has the clock to eat up if it can.
And if anyone was looking for the onside kick there, I think the thinking, at least as far as Tennessee was concerned, their defensive unit, with the exception of that one interception, it's been pretty much their whole ball game in the second half. They've been holding them. They've had a hot hand. They figure that they can do it again with this much time remaining. 3:56.
Oklahoma has never been behind and would not want to fall behind now. And look at Steve Owen. First down out across the 30 to the 33. Oklahoma continues to use its tailbacks, Ron Johnson, Steve Owen. Now, because we may have to leave the air in a hurry, we'll tell you that Bob Womack scored on a 7-yard run in the first quarter, threw 21 yards to Eddie Hinton in the second quarter. Steve Owen scored a touchdown from 1 foot out in the second quarter, and it was 19-0 at halftime. Into the second half action in the moment. Gillingsworth to the right. Sable to the left. Again, it is Owens, and this time it gets across the 35 and to the 36. In this wild and woolly second half, Jimmy Glover of Tennessee put the Volunteers on the scoreboard for the first time with a 36-yard pass interception returned for a touchdown. Later, Charlie Fulton, just 2 minutes later, set up by Weatherford's interception, scored from 5 yards out, made it 19-14. And then Kremser kicked a field goal of 26 yards to make it 19-17. Bobby Stevenson returned a interception for 26 yards to make it 26-17, and Warren has just scored for Tennessee as Owens carries the ball again. And here we are, all 77,943 of us, with 2 minutes and 40 seconds to go, and it's 26-24.
And Tennessee obviously has tightened up its defensive unit. They figure that Oklahoma will not put the ball in the air. However, at this point, it looks as though Oklahoma will have to.
Our statistician today, Jim Davis. Our spotters from Oklahoma, Dave Terrell, and the Tennessee, Gus Manning. And gentlemen, for the remaining 2 minutes and 20 seconds, good luck to the both of you. Owens goes again. Out near the first down, they'll have to measure. Or perhaps they can tell it is not, but they're going to call for time. 2 minutes and 9 seconds to go. They are saying that he did not get the first down. At least that's the initial indication. Bob Kalsu, the All-American strong side tackle from Del City, Oklahoma, is standing there, number 77, and he would like it measured.
From our vantage point, Jim, it would look to be about, a half a foot.
Right. You're close.
That's we're in the wrong vantage point.
But it is still short. Now it is fourth down. Oklahoma has the two-point lead. Gordon Wheeler, the punter, is still on the sidelines. On fourth down and inches to go in Oklahoma territory, apparently Chuck Fairbanks has given them the go-ahead to try for it. Hinton in motion. Owens with the ball, and I don't know whether or not he got it. Chuck Fairbanks took a whale of a gamble, and they're going to measure. Now they say, no, sir, first down, Tennessee.
Well, as usual, Jim, there'll be, I'm sure, some second-guessing along the way, particularly because of Tennessee's fine field goal kicker, even if they get there within field goal range now as far as he's concerned.
Jack Reynolds stacked him up. There is Chuck Fairbanks, the 34-year-old coach who gave his young team the go-ahead. And now he must perspire out the remaining moments. Dewey Warren carries inside the 40. Down to the 38. Nick Peso made the stop. 1 minute and 30 seconds to go. 26 to 24, Oklahoma. Clock is rolling. Here comes Tennessee. What a ball game. Warren hands to Fulton, and down he goes to Kretschmer. Kretschmer, the senior from Oklahoma, replacing the injured Granville Liggins, number 55, made the tackle. Clock is still rolling. Our production stage manager has been James O'Gorman, and our thanks to him. The ball is at the 39. Third down, 7. Tennessee not calling time. 55 seconds to go. In motion comes Chadwick. Warren with the ball. Setting up lots of time. Now throws it short and incomplete at the 34-yard line to Richmond Flowers. That stops the clock. 45 seconds to go.
I think Richmond Flowers and Kenny DeLong got a little mix-up in their assignment over there. They were both standing, oh, I would say within 5 feet of each other. Finally, Warren had to, I think, and almost intentionally throw that away.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed this New Year's Day triple-header. And as a football fan myself, I don't see how you could not have. Chris comes to the left. Flowers to the right. In motion comes Fulton. 45 seconds left. Fourth down, 6. Over the middle, he drops the man for the first down. Getting up is DeLong, Kenny DeLong, at the 29-yard line. First down, 25 seconds to go.
And that's the man he has gone to in every other key situation.
20 seconds to go. Chris to the left. Warren hands to Pickens. Now they're calling time from right in front of the goalpost from the 26-yard line. 14 seconds showing. And apparently they're going to leave it up to Carl Kremser. Doug Dickey has not yet sent him in. The Tennessee team looking to the bench. Here he comes. Kremser never kicked a football before February of this year. And against LSU, with 1 minute to go, he kicked one of 43 yards to beat LSU 17-14. LSU went on to be victorious in the Sugar Bowl. This ball will be spotted. I believe he's spotting it at the 34, which would be 44 yards, within a yard of his 1 minute to go kick that beat LSU. Let us look from the end zone. Kneeling is Dewey Warren, 14 seconds to go. Carl Kremser, the youngster from Germany, who was found by the boys at Tennessee and reported to the coaches last winter, will try it from the 33. It'll be 43 yards again. Can lightning strike twice? The kick is up. The kick is off to the side. No good. Oklahoma goes wild as Tennessee walks dejectedly from the field. 7 seconds showing. And for a moment, the big gamble of Chuck Fairbanks, Kyle wrote, almost backfired.
And now it's just a matter of running the clock out as far as Oklahoma is concerned. And as you have said, Jim, what a ball game.
The winning touchdown will go down as the 26-yard pass interception by Bobby Stevenson.